and Jeannie Bartholomew. Are you ready for the live action, Matt?
Yeah, I can't wait. I'm ecstatic. They're in, out of the aircraft right now?
I've been told, Dad has been told that Chris Stewart is already out of the helicopter. So if we can switch and see him there, that would be fantastic. What's he going to be giving us here in this first round, Voggy?
Well, Chris is going to be giving us a left-hand 630-degree turn. So that's a 270 and a 360-degree whip at the end. Possible points will be 8 points for the turn. And then he's going to be going into a ghost rider lazy boy. So leaning back in the harness, right, trying to get level with the floor, and then taking his hands off the controls completely.
Well, he's starting his turn right now. Let's switch the view to the sky, because he's coming in. Chris Stewart with his first run of the afternoon. That's going to give him the scores. He's in the air right now. Chris Stewart, here he is. Talk us through, Fog.
Let's have a look. Okay, he's lined up very nicely. Leaning back into there, taking his arms off. Wonderful attempt from Chris. Wonderful. Just missed it onto the right-hand side, I think. Looks like the setup was a lot better for him on this one.
I think we're going to have probably a few more people onto the platform this afternoon, do you?
I think so. After that practice round, now they've got their setup properly. Definitely. We need to get that boat out there for him. There we go. There's the handshake. Great effort from Chris Stewart there.
Yeah, he was in 16th place overnight. Made it into the finals, into the top 16. Came through in his practice round about an hour ago. Wasn't very happy with it, but he's put down now his round one move. Let's have a look at the slow motion.
Okay, so again, the very nice turn. Coming in bang on target there, leaning right back, taking his arms off, looking for the controls. Just, I think he just caught one riser on the right hand side, not the left one, just pulled him off to the right, but excellent work.
Yeah, Ghost Rider looks great. Wonderful. He's got his hands off the toggles, lazy boy. Think he would have been on the platform if he wouldn't have gotten that?
I think so. I think he just missed that left control, and it just pulled him off to the right hand side, unfortunately.
Well, there's a good shot of him now, just getting on the boat. We do know local talent from Denmark, Christian Weber, will be our next canopy pilot through the course into this second scoring round of the Swoop Challenge. One round done last night, Nick Batch taking the overall lead, and now we're into the second round. One more round to come after that to find our Swoop Challenge champion of 2016. What are we expecting from Christian Weber, Matt?
Okay, so doing it for Denmark is Christian Weber. He's going to be doing a boomerang Superman. So basically the boomerang is coming around and carving while dragging the water, so making like a turn into the pontoon, and then leaning right forward in the harness to look like a Superman. So he's looking to get right close to the water itself for maximum multiplier 4.8.
We didn't see any Superman moves yesterday,
did we? Yesterday, no. We didn't get to them, so fingers crossed. It's quite a nice move. It looked great, so hopefully he pulls it off, and he can see the pontoon all the way through.
We're going to go over to Irish now for a quick interview with Chris Stewart.
For Chris Stewart to come up now. Chris, absolutely fantastic first round, setting the pace for everyone else coming up. Come on up here and let's have a talk. So he came into the course a lot better setup than your last one. How are you feeling about that first round?
I don't think I've set a very great pace, but it's a pace to be sure.
Well, we definitely got it underway. Leading into the next round, anything you want to change, anything you want to do?
Just do better, I guess. It's about, I don't know, the next trick's different anyway. It's going to be carving, so hopefully I can improve on the practice round.
Beautiful, thank you very much. We'll see you in round two. Chris, back to you in the studio, guys.
Well, we had Timmy Thompson about an hour ago coming through in his practice round, Danish competitor, and he raised the roof off this place. He put it down right in the centre off the platform with a really good trick as well. Teammate from Denmark, Christian Weber. Foggy, what we're going to see here?
Okay, so he's going to be doing a 450-degree turn. So it's a 90-degree and then a 360. It's quite a lower turn than most of the guys are doing, but therefore more accurate. So if you can pull it off, you should score high. And then, as I said, he's going to be doing this boomerang Superman move. So the first Superman we've seen here. So yeah. Let's keep our fingers crossed. It's a good one for Chris.
You were saying that a lot of these competitors like to do that last bit of a turn with a snap on the end. The judges were saying in their interview they're looking for more of a control, smooth turn, so a bit of a odds apart there.
It is a little bit, yeah. It does give you a little bit more power. I suppose the judges are looking for no alterations during the turn. So
right.
Often if you start a little bit high, you can stop the turn, keep the canopy in the dive, and then continue a little bit later on. But what they're looking for is a smooth turn all the way around for maximum points.
Okay, we're just going to check the skies outside the studio now, see if we can get eyes on Weber. He's going to be there somewhere. Yeah, I can see him. He's directly above our studio right now, so we have got a little bit of time. What we saw there from Chris Stewart, he said he was, you know, he was happier than his practice round. He's got another round to come there with his carving move. He seems to be looking forward to that.
Yeah, he's going to, well, we'll see this on this one, and then after this, he's going to be doing a different move. I can't really tell you what it is right now. So at the moment, when these guys jump out, they've got a lot to do. So they need to exit around 5,000, 6,000 feet. Lots of things to do. They're going to take off their slider, which helps slow down the parachute on the deployment, and also take off their chest straps so they can lean forward in the harness. Christian actually was the Danish national champion in 2014-2015, so I bet the crowd are rooting for him.
Yeah, he likes mountain biking and snowboarding as well, but he's about to set up for his turn, I think.
There we go, deep brakes now, it looks like.
Clear skies, high clouds above us, it's looking great for the rest of the evening.
That's it, looks like he's on his downward. This setup approach is so important for the actual final turn. It's actually one of the most important things, to get yourself in the right place, take the time. Here we go through the turn, stopping a little bit, giving that whip. A lot of power on this, it looks like. Lovely contact with the water, popping it up. He's on the pontoon. Excellent work, Christian.
Great stuff.
They're going to be happy.
Christian Weber putting it down just like Timmy Thompson did, right in the middle of the pontoon in front of a crowd of what's got to be up to 100,000 people here at Pebbelinga. So here's the slow motion. Can we see the tricks, the boomerang and the Superman?
Yeah, we're going to have a look. Okay, so bang on the course. Here's the boomerang now. So he's leaning over. Contact with the water is great. Going to the toggles, trying to lean forward. I think he just didn't have enough time to actually perform the Superman, but great performance on the landing. Excellent work.
Yeah, we do get another shot, I think, here from the side, which might show us that Superman a little bit better. Can we see it? There's the boomerang. He's going to get in and lean forward.
It's a nice long boomerang as well, keeping good contact with the water. He just ran out of room, I think, at the end. But bang, look at in the middle of the pontoon. Wonderful stuff.
Well, good stuff there. Just like Timmy Thompson from Denmark, in the middle of the pontoon. Christian Weber bringing it home. Let's give a big cheer, ladies and gentlemen. Over to you, Irish, for the interview.
Thank you very much, guys. I'm here for Christian Weber. Copenhagen, give it up for Christian Weber! Christian, round one. Absolutely great jump. You gave the thumbs up to the crowd. How, you must be happy with that one.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that one. It's nice to be dry this time, not to land in the water. So, yeah, I'm pretty happy with that one.
Beautiful. And you think it's added extra pressure, or it's definitely in your favor, jumping in your home city?
I think that's my favorite now, to jumping here. Yeah, definitely.
Beautiful, thank you very much. We've got round two coming up. Get back to it. Thank you very much. Christian Weber, back to you guys in the studio.
This is live action. It is Swoop Challenge 2016, being watched worldwide and right here now with a big crowd at Pebblinger Lake. If you just watched us on the live feed, a very good afternoon, and this doesn't get any better than what we've had now. The practice round was absolutely incredible. We were watching it live, we were emceeing it live. The crowd were going crazy. Now, to the sky, we've got Ian Bobo.
Bobo's up, and he's going to be doing a left-hand 630-degree turn and going into a boomerang cowboy. So that carve again, trying to get contact with the water, and then taking one of the arms off his controls and trying to touch the water as well for a multiplier of 5.4.
I think was this the trick we saw him have a go at yesterday in practice?
I think so,
or
yeah.
Or it was round one, actually. It wasn't practice, yeah. He just did the one round.
I think he did pretty well, and then just landed short of the pontoon, if I remember rightly. So let's have a look up at the sky. Okay, he's almost at the setup point now. You can see the canopy's flying very slowly towards where, in the direction. Looks like a little bit of a crosswind still. Into the turn, front rises down now. Leaning into the harness for the left hand. One more 360 to go. There we go. There's a nice work getting it vertical. A lot of speed on the course. Wonderful touch, touching the water, nice and smooth. Oh, in the water. Well done, Bobo. Good effort.
Yeah, yesterday he had quite a deep start with lots of water contact. His boomerang was a good hard car, but he didn't get that simultaneous water contact yesterday. What do you think about that one? Let's have a look at the slow-mo.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see. He had a great setup, great speed, and something just went wrong in the last moment, I think. So wonderfully vertical there. Other speed through the course. Very tight. I don't think he managed to get rid of his control toggle to actually get his hand in. So maybe that was the problem. He was just trying to get it out. Oh.
Yeah.
I think the canopy dived to the left as he took his arm off, then tried to correct and couldn't do it. But great effort, Bobo.
Yeah, he's on the safety boat now, making his way back to the bridge area. After that, we're going to get Jeannie Bartholomew. She had a really good practice. She was happy with that there. What's she giving us, Foggy, on the next one?
She's going to give us a left-hand 450, one of the lowest scoring dives, but the more accurate. So fingers crossed she can do it. I've seen her turns before. They're very graceful. She's doing it for the girls, just showing that it's definitely a unisex sport, this. She's the only one competing, only female, but she's doing amazing, amazing stuff. She's going to be doing a lazy girl switchblade, so leaning right back in the harness like we've seen the lazy boy, and then swapping the controls over to one hand and then trying to fly the canopy just with one hand. It's so very difficult to do.
I look forward to seeing that. Bobo's making his way out of the boat over to Irish.
Yes, we got Ian Bobo coming out now, looking nice and wet. He's just got a line around the back there. The move looking really good, had nice power coming into it, but just didn't have enough pace to get out of it. We are seeing a lot of people hit the pontoon, so I know Bobo will be keen. Come on up here, Bobo. Copenhagen, please give it up for Ian Bobo! Okay, Ian, so first jump, the first round. Are you happy with that first one?
Definitely not.
What could you improve on for the next one?
I could do the move I planned, do the turn I planned, everything. Yeah,
so
it wasn't good. It wasn't a good one. Not a good start.
So we're just going to step it up and bring the noise in the next one?
Yeah, man. Stay positive. Thank you, man.
That's it, Ian. I believe in you. Thanks. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Irish. Obviously, Bobo not happy there, Foggy. Got a score of 45.9. That's what we've been given there by the judges. He's disappointed with that run.
Well, disappointed, yeah, but it is early stages, and we'll see. We've got a lot of competitors to go, so even 45.9, we'll see how the other people deal with the conditions. So it might be he works out okay, but I'm sure he's looking forward to his second jump to make up those points.
This is Genie being followed on camera by Michael McCann.
Wonderful.
He's getting themselves to the setup point now.
He's testing the wind, testing that crosswind. That crosswind can bring a little bit of turbulence off the buildings as well. You might notice that if you see a flutter with the canopy, the parachute itself. Deep brakes now, taking the pressure out of the canopy and onto the front risers to dip it down to gain that speed. Starting the harness turn. Looking good, Jeannie. That whip at the end. Looks like she's pretty on the target. Right, left. Whoa, she's right back. She's done it. And she's just slipped off, but she looked the trick looked good.
Oh, that three trick move, the lazy girl, switchblade, cowgirl. It was with the lazy switch, wasn't it? Lazy girl, switchblade we're looking for.
Back and then transferring those toggles into one hand, flying the canopy on there. Let's see whether she got them back into both of her other hands.
I thought she was going to put it down in the center of the pontoon.
Oh, I did as well.
There's a lot of water out there right now.
So we're going to slow-mo this.
Off the deep brakes.
Starting the dive into the turn. It can get up to 110 miles an hour in this turn. Letting the canopy level off before she touches the water. That's a great effort. A lot better than yesterday. There we go. The hands off. Back into the both toggles. Just slipping off at the end, unfortunately. But what a great effort from Jeannie.
Those tricks looked amazing.
That was brilliant. Very technical. So that was a 4.9.
See it from the side here.
Oh,
now
here
we'll see that lean back.
Right, leaning back there. Switching over. Showing the judges that she's got her hands off. Oh, unfortunately, just slipping off. What amazing accuracy, though. So slippy out there, very easy to do. Well done.
Wow, that was an incredible performance there. It looked perfect with the trick. Mike McCann filling it on camera. He had a good old tumble at the end too. Wow, look at this air shot now from the helicopter. Live footage now from the helicopter. The AS350 Airbus that is flying above us. If you look up, you can see it. They can see you. There it goes. This is what it looks like to jump out of a moving aircraft, ladies and gents. Now we're going to go to Irish. Irish, to you, sir.
Jeannie Bartholomew, an absolute inspiration to all women out there, showing the guys how it's done on the course. You must be happy with that first one.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. I wish I would have stayed on the raft, but it was awesome.
So you're kind of doing the same move on the next round. What would you change? Anything you'd do differently leading into the next jump?
Just get a little bit more laid out on the water so I can get that cowgirl added in there.
Absolutely fantastic. Go, girls. Jeannie, we're rooting for you. Back to you guys in the studio.
Great job there by Jeannie. Big, massive smile as well. We are halfway through the competition. We had one round of competition last night. This is the second round now, and one more round to come after that. So it's all lined up for a great final, Foggy.
That's it. We can't wait. So we've got the we're going to finish this round into round two, and then we'll see who is the winner of the $10,000 prize.
It's round two of the finals. We had the qualifier last night, and this is two rounds of the finals now. So it's three rounds in total of a live competition. Well, Jeannie, he's going to be followed now by Junior. That crazy trick we saw from him before.
It was a twist Miracle Man Ghost Rider, twisting in the harness full 360 degrees before he's doing his turn. He's not going to do that on this turn, on this jump, but on the next one we'll see it again, so fingers crossed he can do it. On this one, he's going to be trying a blind man switchblade cowboy. So turning 180 degrees in the harness once he's over the water, switching the toggles into one hand, or the control column toggles into one hand, and then trying to put one of the arms in the water as well. Very, very tricky trick to do, with 5.9 multiplier on this. And he's going to be doing another 1080, so that's three 360 degree turns, the biggest turns out of all the competitors on this.
There he goes, that's his last turn now.
Nice and smooth. Onto the course. Great contact with the water. He's going to turn, switch, yeah, he's gone Miracle Man. It looked like he turned 180, so he's got the blind man.
Yes.
He switched over, flying the canopy with one arm, amazing, and got the cowboy in. I think he turned around, carried on turning the same way, actually giving him the Miracle Man, so we'll see what the judges think of that. But a great effort from Junior.
There's a slow-mo.
Nice, smooth turn. Little correction there. Beautiful contact, smooth contact with the water. Waiting just until he's ready. Boom, there's the hand for the cowboy, keeping on going, and he's touched the pontoon as well. He should get 2.5 points for touching the pontoon too.
So he turned that blind man into a Miracle Man. That's a 360 degree turn through the harness.
Exactly. If only you put that on paper, I think it would have scored pretty much maximum points for that one.
There's a water contact. Great shot here. There's the turn. Hand down for the cowboy.
Brilliant. Flying the canopy with one hand, so difficult to do. Just one little twitch left or right, and that thing can go in the water very quickly.
Waiting for Junior to make his way. More exits there from that great helicopter cam. Amazing there. The door gets shut for the next round as they go around. That's Noah Banson, who's just waiting there in the helicopter. We saw Rhys Kempton out. We're going to Irish for his interview with Junior.
Here comes Junior up now, third place last year, and showing us what he did with an absolutely sensational jump there. Your first practice round didn't go to plan. You must be happy with that last jump.
Yeah, Irish, absolutely, man. That was a lot better. I needed a redemption swoop after the first one.
And I believe I just found out that your new move, the Twist Miracle Ghost Rider, is called the Cyclone. You renamed that yourself?
Absolutely. I just did it for the first time in the competition, so I get to name it, right?
Yeah, you did. So you're going to do it again in the next round?
We're going to go for it and see what happens.
Beautiful. Thank you much, Dave. Good luck to it. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thank you very much, guys. Junior there pulling off a great score. From a maximum of 100 points, he scores 71.0. And that is the new maximum best for today. That's what we've seen. He's at the top of the pack in this round so far. 71 points to Junior.
Excellent work, Junior. That really was great. And up next, we've got Rhys Kempton from New Zealand. He's going to be doing a left-hand 810, so one of the biggest turns for maximum points, 10 points available on the turn here. Going into a method cowboy. So the method is turning 90 degrees in the harness, trying to drag both feet and keeping those feet really far apart, and then also trying to touch the water with his hand. Very, very difficult to do those two for a 5.4 multiplier. So let's see how he does. Looks like he's going to start his turn now into that dive. Waiting till the canopy speeds up a little bit, gets a little bit of pressure before using the harness to turn the canopy. Keeping that thing going. We need one more 360 to get it really vertical, get all the power. There we go. Right on the course. He looks bang on now. There we go. I think he just, as he released, canopy dived to the left, unfortunately for him. But he had good contact with the water at the beginning, so I'd like to see that in slow motion.
So we'll see that slow motion shortly. The turn, the 8-10, it looked nice and smooth. It looked like what they were looking for, the judges.
Exactly. Either way, he's going to have a big smile on his face, Rhys. Okay. Lovely turn. No real correction on there. Bang on target. Waiting to for his moment to do the method. He's got it. I think he should score all right on that one. He didn't bring it back, didn't land on the pontoon, but he got his hand in the water, so he should get some points for that trick.
To the cowboy. One more view here from front on. Nice shot.
Beautiful. Nice and smooth that leg. Look at that. So he's twisted in the harness. He should get some nice points.
So the method should be good. We're looking like that's nice. He's got that twist in the harness. And then the cowboy getting that hand down to the water. So it's looking good for the scores,
exactly,
you think?
Yeah, I think it's unfortunately, obviously, after that he crashed in. But it, for such a difficult move, you know, that's pretty much expected. These guys are going really hard on their tricks today.
A 5.4 multiplier available to him there. Still to come, Noah Banson and Gage Garley.
Yep, Noah Banson from the USA, also with a left-hand 8-10. He's going to be doing a Miracle Man Ghost Rider. So a Miracle Man is turning the full 360 degrees in the harness while you're over the water, and then the Ghost Rider is letting go with both of your hands from the controls, so letting the canopy fly. This is a 5.9 multiplier.
We're going to go to Irish now for his interview with Rhys.
We've got a very wet Rhys coming up the platform. Do the walk. Walk it up. Strut it up, Rhys. Round one of competition. This is what you flew all the way from New Zealand here for. You did good in the practice round. How did you think about that jump?
It was all right. It wasn't as good as I'd hoped, but not bad. A bit of water. Lost a shoe.
You lost the shoe. We'll get someone out there to find it. You had some trouble with your setup and turbulence and everything before. This time you didn't. Did it feel much more comfortable up there?
I just sort of made some adjustments based on the last one, so it was a bit better the setup, but execution wasn't the best, but it's okay.
Beautiful. Your setup and everything looked great. Just caught a bit too much water there. Good luck in round two. Wishing you the best of luck here. Cheer, bro. Back to you in the studio.
There's Noah Banson winding it up. Miracle Ghost Rider is what we're looking for, Foggy.
That's right. Let's see how he does. Okay.
Oh,
there we go.
So Ghost Rider. Went for the Ghost Rider first.
He went for the Ghost Rider first and then tried to spin around. At least he got 180 degrees, I think, at least on that. So didn't complete the Miracle Man all the way, but did a great effort despite that.
Just before that, Rhys Kenton pulls in a score of 5.7.1. 5.7.1, Rhys Kenton. Noah Banson there being pulled out of the water. Let's have a look at the replay of what happened right there.
Okay, so he's in the turn here, whipping it around with his hips, keeping that speed all the way through the turn, nice and vertical. Leveling off with the rear rises, controlling the canopy. They're off the controls. Oh, I think he got it almost around full 360 degrees then. So he's got to be happy with that.
Right, so yes, he had that 360 degree turn there and the...
There we go,
there
almost
it is.
Around. I think he just caught a knee or a foot in the water and it just dinked him in. Back up to the live feed.
Live feed there from the helicopter, Gage Galley. He's going to be followed on camera as well. We should have the live feed on the camera from Pablo Hernandez on this run, so it's going to be fantastic if we can see that.
This will be great footage. So Gage will be doing a boomerang cowboy, so carving it up again, trying to drag the water and then taking off one arm and trying to touch that as well, while Pablo will be coming in with that live feed behind him. Very difficult flying with two canopies very close to each other. These guys are professionals. They're part of the PD Factory team, practicing every day to do this. But the last time we had the live feed, it was great fitness. Did you see it, Regan?
Yeah, it was absolutely amazing. It was Mike McCann following... Who was he following? I can't quite remember now, but it was... It was Travis. Yes, Travis Mills. And they were both actually onto the platform.
That was incredible. So let's see where the... These guys are. Helicopters up there, I can see. These guys are in the air. Just well, going through their setup jumps now. So these guys are going to...
There we go, there's a live feed. They're out. So this is Pablo Hernandez chasing Gage Galley. There's Gage Galley on the screen. And we're going to go to Iris for a quick interview with Noah Banzer.
I've got Noah Banzer coming down here first last year. Noah, last year you had one big last one that won you. Have you got it in you for the next round?
We'll see, man. So far it's not doing too good, but hopefully we can pull it out in the last one. We'll see.
It's okay. I believe in you. You did that big one last year. You went in first and you brought it home. We believe in you. Do it now in the next round. Back to you guys in the studio for the live feed.
Thank you very much. Here we go. Live feed of Gage Galley in the air, being followed by Pablo Hernandez Mal. We've got the ground shot there. Let's get the live feed shot. There it is. There That's the one we're looking for. So you can see the pontoon in the middle of the pebbling of the lake. And you can see Gage there with his eyes on the target.
Excellent. So he's just setting up now. Should be doing a 630-degree turn. It's great to see this footage. You can really see what the skydivers are seeing here. So into the first 90, 270, one more 360 to go. The ground rushing up at the guys, looking for the course now. And he's going to be coming in as a carve. There's the carve there. There's the hand down. Onto the rear risers. And he's on the pontoon. Great effort, Gage. Excellent work. That was just smooth all the way.
They're both there. They both landed on it. Gage got it.
Pablo as well. Pablo.
Look at the reactions here. They are ecstatic with that. That's 2 out of 2 for Pablo. Both times he's filmed, he has been there on the platform. Just to tell you, Noah Banson got a score of 5-1.3. 5-1.3 for Noah Banson. Here's that live feed. Repeated.
That was just incredible. Such smooth flying. Great control. Just chilling out over the water. I just touched my foot, hand in. Onto the rears to get him over. And then boom, onto his knees. Excellent work. He should score very, very highly for this one.
And the boomerang, how did that look? Let's see.
Okay. So, yeah, the wing's over. He's contact with the water all the way.
He's going to be so impressed with that. His mother's here in the
Brilliant.
VIP watching as well.
That was just wonderful to see. Skydiving, swooping at its best.
Incredible system that we can broadcast the pictures from one skydiver, filming another one, down to us here and put it out live to the world. How good is that, Matt?
Well, it's incredible. It's a first for I think... ever. This is the first time it's ever been done on live television.
Yeah, so it's been used a few months ago out at an event over in Europe as well. They had some footage too. But there you go, Gage Galley's just pulled the lines from around his neck. In the safety boat with Pablo Hernandez Mal. This is the finals of Swoop Challenge. 2 rounds this evening for you. And we are halfway through the pack. An incredible day of action. Just looking around at what I can see with the crowd. Look at the bridge there behind us, bathed in sunlight. Hundreds and hundreds, thousands of people on the other side as well, where the sunshine still is. And here's Gage running up for his interview with Irish.
Here we go. Gage is coming up after an absolutely fantastic jump. What do you put down to the haircut for that jump?
It absolutely crushed you on that one. I was carving in there, and as I leaned back, I think I felt like it flowed really well in the wind. Got a nice grab back on my rear to make the raft.
That is going to be a huge scoring jump that's setting you up for the next round. You must be feeling confident going into the last round.
Yeah, man, I'm all in it to win it right now. Here we go.
Beautiful. We'll see you on the podium, hopefully. Back to you guys in the studio.
We just missed Lee Barraclough there with his roll. Let's see if we can get it.
The double brown, he's on the pontoon. I think he went through and did his signature move, which is the double brown, touching the water and then holding both feet with his arms, so like a tick jockey is doing, holding one foot with your hand, and he's gone crazy and just done it with both.
Here we go, he's in slow motion. Let's see if he managed to pull it off, holding both his feet in both his hands.
Here he comes out of the dive now. Nice contact with the water, popping up, grabbing those feet, or did he grab them? But he's bang in the middle of the pontoon, just sliding it off. He's got to be very, very, very happy with that move.
Look at his reaction. Excellent arms work. In the air, well, clapping and cheering.
Leroy Brown, the one and only.
There's his turn one more time. Came very fast there.
Yeah, a lot of speed. He set it, looks like he set it just perfectly. I don't know whether he got his both feet along, but it's such a difficult move, that one. I mean, he's made this one up. It's a multiplier of 6.
Yeah. Well, he'll get his interview with Irish, and we'll get the scores on the screen and find out. Just before that, Gage Galley at 6.7.4. That's 6.7.4. Lee Barraclough now with Irish.
Lee Barrett off the flying Kiwi. Here he comes up the podium. We finally see the Leroy Brown. Are you happy with your performance, with your first time on the main stage with the Leroy Brown?
Oh, mate, I'm pretty happy with that, got to say. I was a lot nicer. I was a lot closer in that last practice round, eh? And the pontoon was coming up. Boom.
So I just got some word that you are the highest scorer at the moment.
Wowza, that's crazy. First place, baby Kiwis.
Woo! Yeah, buddy, so that leaves you really good leaving into the next round. We're going to leave you, get back to it. Have a great round two, and let's see if we can get a Kiwi on the podium.
Cheers, Irish. Nice one.
Back to you guys in the studio.
Yes, as Irish then had put out the scoop, it's Lee Barraclough with the biggest goal so far this afternoon, 7.7.8. Lee Barraclough takes the lead in this round one of the final.
Excellent work, Lee. It's so great to see. He's been working on that move for quite a while, but he's just pulled it off for the first time, got great score in front of the thousands of people and live on television.
Well, next up, Timmy Thompson. He set this place alight half an hour ago with his practice run right in the middle of the pontoon. Is he going to do that again?
He's going to be going for a blind man and a miracle man on this one. Multiplier of 6, so he's going to be turning a 180 and then another 360 in the harness. Let's see how he does on this one.
He's had his setup. He had a blind switch cowboy in practice and put it down right in the middle of the landing pontoon.
That was it.
Can he do that again?
Great setup before. He's doing a left-hand 450. So quite an accurate turn, which probably helped him out on the last round, and it will do on this one. Keeping low, less points on the turn, but very accurate, trying to get those landing points. So here we go, final whip. Looks nice and calm. Well, bounced a little bit, but he's going to make the pontoon. He's on. Oh, looked like quite a hard impact on the pontoon. Is he okay?
Yeah, he's punching the air with his hand there.
Excellent.
So we're looking for a blind man and a miracle man. So that's a 180 and a 360, isn't
it? That's right. Well, unfortunately, it looks like he just touched the water a bit too hard. If the canopy's still a little bit in the dive, you can skip up. It skips you up like a skipping stone.
Yeah.
Pops you very high and very difficult to continue the move after that. But the setup was great. The power, the space between him and the pontoon looked good. It was just unfortunate, just hit that water a little bit too hard with his legs, maybe just came out a little bit low on the turn, but kept it flying. Still wants those points for the landing, and he will score something for that as well. Boom.
Splash down.
So there he is coming back in the boat. We'll get the interview soon. Looks like he's got a big smile on his face.
Still to come from this load, Travis Mills, Kurt Bartholomew, and it's going to be from the helicam as well, I believe.
Excellent. Who have we got up next? Travis.
Next up is going to be Travis Mills, and he is lining up his turn right now.
Another 450. And then into a boomerang cowboy, so carving it round, touching the water with that hand. We've seen these ones before. Let's see how he does today. Okay, still pretty high in the sky.
Quick word with Irish. Travis is setting up, so get a quick one with Irish.
Timmy Thompson, are you okay after that one?
Yeah, I'm all right. All good.
Beautiful. You've got your signature move coming up next. We wish you the best of luck in that one. Bring it home for the Danes. Back to you guys.
Okay.
So Timmy Thompson with a 41.9 there. 41.9. Travis Mills now with a boomerang cowboy.
And a left 450. So he's coming in for his crosswind now. He should be turning towards the course. And then another 360 to get that power and dive it down. Here we go now. Front rises, bringing the canopy down. Down, building up the speed, keeping it nice and smooth. Well done. Looks like he's coming in crosswind. Good for the boomerang. Awesome. Bang on the pontoon. Excellent work. Excellent work.
Look at his reaction there, punch in the sky. Big smile. He put it down on the pontoon in practice, and he's done it again in round one.
Wonderful. Looks like he got a good cowboy in there as well. Smooth flying, absolutely great flying from Travis.
Let's check it out on the replay. Let's see exactly how he managed there with that boomerang cowboy. Here it is, Matt.
Okay, so flying the canopy on deep brakes, just getting to the right point over the water. Very difficult to set up over water. There's no reference points, but he seems to have nailed it. Getting nice and small, whipping it round. No adjustments needed there. He knew exactly what he was going to do. Got his hand in the water, and then just slid on. He's got to be very happy with that. Look at that.
Well, that's, I mean, we saw Lee Barakloff with that, the double, his double brown with a multiplier of 6. He took the lead with a 7.8.
Well, this was good clean flying, so let's see how the points work out for Travis.
We're in the helicopter now live with Kurt Bartholomew, just checking and waiting for his position. Ladies and gentlemen, in the crowd, have a look at the big screen there. That's what your home city looks like. He's got the thumbs up, he's got 1 foot outside, he's big wave to the camera, and out he goes into free fall. Check it out. Head down position before he opens his parachute. What we're going to get there from Travis Mills on the scores? It looked great. The scores were the boomerang cowboy, Timmy Thompson with his blinded miracle. It was a good landing.
Just looked incredible. It was great flying, smooth. He looked relaxed the whole way through the course, even onto the pontoon, and just super happy.
We're going to go to Irish for an interview.
Travis Mills, you must be happy with that jump. Absolutely fantastic boomerang, and you got to touch some water with the cowboy.
I got it, man. Yeah, I felt really good. Run felt great, turn felt great. It's good conditions, man.
That's got to give you great confidence and a big score going into the final. Do you reckon you could take this competition out?
Heck yeah, man. Anything could happen.
In it to win it. Thank you very much, Travis. We wish you the best of luck. Back to you guys in the studio.
Travis Mills there with 6.1.9 in the lead right now. Lee Barraclough 7.7.8. Look at the difference in the turns though. Barraclough had an 8.10. Travis Mills at a 4.50.
That's it, yeah. The turn will give you quite a lot of points, but as I said, it's very difficult to be accurate. Lee managed to nail it. You've got to start pretty much double the height, you know, for an 8.10 from a 4.50. So it may be that the bigger turns are going to come out on top, especially if there's less wind now. These guys are going to know the course, the distances are going to travel over the pond.
So next up we've got Kurt Bartholomew with a big turn. He's got the left 8.10 and he's looking for his Lazy Boy, Switchblade and Cowboy.
Yeah, so he's going to be leaning back, riding the harness, switching those control toggles into one hand, flying the canopy like that, and then reaching down with one arm and touching the floor. Very, very tricky maneuver, but he's very good at this move. We're looking for a multiplier of 5.6.
There he is, onto the pontoon again.
Whoa, everyone's getting it right now. So looks like the conditions are good. That practice round helped everybody out. So these guys are nailing it right now.
And a great response from the crowd here. Good afternoon, Copenhagen. Good afternoon to everybody watching on the world feed. This is the finals of Swoop Challenge 2016. We got this round, and then we got the final second round as well, and then we'll know who our champion is. Let's have a look at the replay of Kurt Bartholomew.
Okay, so world champion Kurt knows what he's doing. Lovely smooth turn, whip at the end, a lot of speed onto the course, a lot of power. Wonderful. He's got that hand in, flying that canopy, grabs the other toggle and just saves himself. The canopy's diving over to the right, but he just got that toggle to make sure he got landed on the pontoon. Wonderful. Ecstatic.
Very happy, both hands in the air. He's cruising down by the bridge, taking the adulation from the crowd. Kurt Bartholomew. Coming up next, we have Tom Baker with his backflip. Oh no, we've got the replay. We've got the replay. That's one.
Oh, yeah.
Get a bit carried away there. On.
Leaning right back there. Wonderful. Even touching the water with his back. That was a great effort from Kurt.
They looked fantastic, didn't they? They looked like a good set of moves from him. He's taking a big round of applause as he travels down past the bridge. Next up, we've got this new trick, this ginger. Well, actually, he's not doing the ginger flip next time, is he? He's doing the method and then the ginger flip, yes.
So a method ginger, well, he was doing the ginger flip, which is his signature move, been making the crowd go crazy, flipping through his rises, full backflip through the canopy itself. But on this one, he's doing a method ginger, so maybe we'll see something new.
We're going to go to Irish now. Let's chat with Kurt Bartholomew.
Kurt Bartholomew, down after a great round. First round, you're used to competition. How do you feel after that one?
Oh, man, I'm feeling really good. The conditions are great. The city's beautiful, man. This is such an amazing event.
And I don't know if you're watching the live feed, but unfortunately, I think you've got a lot of competition with Jeannie. She had an absolutely fantastic round.
Awesome. I didn't get to see her run. I was in the helicopter, but that's great to hear.
She did great, mate. Good luck in the next round. Back to you in the studio.
Kurt Bartholomew. Kurt Bartholomew gets a score of 74.9. 74.9. Tom Baker is starting his run right now.
Okay, so let's have a look at Tom coming in for a left 450. Nice and slow. Nice and smooth. Keeping it go around. Getting the power there with the whip. Hopefully he'll be coming in with a method and then a try and do a ginger flip.
Yes, he's
there
going
it
for it.
He's done it. He's done it. He's very close to the pontoon.
Just misses the pontoon. An incredible ginger flip, keeping that canopy straight down the middle.
Incredible. A lot more control than we saw yesterday as well. It just one of the most unique moves out there at the moment.
Such a big smile. Here comes a slow motion. Nice turn.
Nice turn, keeping it smooth. Coming across from the right, trying to get that method. And then, boom, very smooth through that. Oh, he was inches away from that pontoon, Regan.
If he would have been on it, he probably would have stopped, wouldn't he? Yes. He's got that much give in it.
Yeah, exactly. It's just great to see. Everyone loves this. Doesn't look like he got the method in, but it's just such a wonderful move. Keeping the canopy directly above his head, flying nicely all the way through.
You could see him looking to the right, seeing the pontoon.
Yeah, he wanted to get there, obviously. But he's going to be super chuffed. He's definitely a crowd pleaser.
Well, it is a multiplier of 6, and the top score we've seen so far, Lee Barraclough, 77.8. Just behind him there, we have Kurt Bartholomew, 74.9, and just behind there, Junior with 7.1. Tom Baker's score is going to be on the screen very shortly. It's going to be interesting to see what he gets with that. No points for the landing, of course, but the turn was sweet. The move was good. What about the method? Do you think we got the method?
I didn't see the method in there, but I think he was just focused. Maybe he didn't have enough power for the method, or he wasn't in the right setup place. But look at that smile.
Let's go to Irish and find out what the reaction is right now.
I've got Tom Baker walking up, the crowd favourite, the Ginger Ninja. Another ginger flip. How do you think that one compared to yesterday?
That felt a lot better, a lot more control, a lot more accurate. We were on target, but man, just off by 2 feet.
I don't know if you can hear the crowd, but they're absolutely going crazy. Are we putting the next one down on the pontoon?
On the pontoon, for sure. That's going to happen today.
Awesome. I can't wait to see you try in the next round. Tom, yeah. Good luck in the next round. Back to you guys in the studio.
So 6-1.5 there for Tom Baker. Again, that smaller turn, the 450, hindering him a little bit, not getting the landing, but the good turn, the 61.5 is his score. Christian Moxes now approaching with Norway, and he's being followed with Helmut Kamm as well. I'm not sure if we've got live feed for that. It would be nice if we have. Probably not, actually, because it's just come through. This will be a recorder. Christian Moxes on the blue and magenta canopy.
Okay, wonderful. So he'll be doing an 8-10 for maximum points, so 10 points if you can do a nice smooth turn. And then just doing a blind man, just one, no combination move. But he needs to be doing it for a long period over the water to get sort of maximum points as well. These guys are flowing nice and close, nice and tight. If that had camera, well, we'll check out the footage later. It's going to be beautiful shots. Okay, so it looks like he's starting the turn now. First 360, one more. Lining up for the pontoon. He should be twisting 180 degrees in the harness. There we go, and he's flying it. He's onto the pontoon. He's done it. Get your hands in. There he is on. He's done it. He's done it. And the cameraman as well.
Incredible. It looked like he was going off the edge for one moment. It looked like he wasn't going to stay there. And he did. He clung on with everything he had. And such a great trick as well.
That was a perfect balance.
We are into the top three of the overnight standings. Christian Moxes was third overnight. Here's the replay.
Here we go into the 8-10. Nice and smooth through the turn. No real stops. So judges should be happy with that one.
An incredible performance by Christian Moxness there. It is the top three from the overnight standings. Look at this trick now, swinging it round.
Full 180's lost his shoe there. There's a lot of shoes in the water.
Everybody's losing their shoes this afternoon, clinging on with everything he had to the end of that pontoon.
That was just a brilliant run from Christian. The man in the suit.
The man in the suit. Watch this great view here now as he turns round. How on earth he managed to stay on there, I have no idea. It's incredible how he managed to pull that off. Well, still to come, the top two of the overnights, Claudio Cagnazzo from Venezuela and Nick Batch from the USA. But look at Moxness there now, being followed by Roger McCulkeny. Both of them actually made it onto the platform.
I saw his canopy go off to the right. Looks like it was going to take him off. He felt that, it looked like, and then jammed that left arm down to get the canopy over to the left and his body to stay on it. Well again, done, Christian.
Big cheers from everybody in the VIP section as the boat makes its way on to the bridge. Irish is standing by for his interview. Over to you, Irish.
We've got Christian Marx coming up now. Definitely a crowd favourite. Give it up for Christian! Absolutely fantastic. You had a really good practice round. You had a really good qualifying round. What do you say to that round? Are you happy with that one?
I'm very happy to land on the raft. I'm not so happy with not touching down earlier. But I did my trick. I landed on the raft, so super happy with that too.
You have another big round. You are in a chance to win this. What are we going to see in the next one?
On the next one, we'll see a lazy boy to a switchblade cowboy.
Beautiful. Which is the best of luck, Christian. Go Norway. Back to you guys in the studio.
Yeah, we've got the top two still coming now. Claudio Cagnazzo, Venezuela, and Nick Batch as well. Set it up now, Claudio.
Okay, yeah, so Claudio is going to be doing a left-hand 8-10, big turn as well, 10-point maximum, and into a blind man switchblade cowboy. So turning 180 in the harness, transferring those controls into the one hand, and then trying to touch the water with his hand as well. Quite a favorite with these guys today.
Well, here he is on deep brakes, finding the edge of the start of his turn. This is incredible action. It's round one of the finals. One more round to come after this, and we've got an air display as well. It's all happening. Here comes a turn.
Here we go. He's going to go into it, keeping his eyes on the target. One more 360. Lining up now. Looks like he's got a lot of power in this one. Great contact with the water. Flying amazingly. Oh, it looked like he was suffering.
I thought he stopped there.
Relaxed, he was just lying back, just letting himself slip in. Even a front flip into the water afterwards.
He dived into the water off the edge, he just gave up and said, that's it, I'm going on and into the water. Here's a slow motion.
But great effort all the way through up until that point. Lovely, lovely control, flying with one hand. Excellent. I don't know whether he got the one arm in the water, but he definitely got the blind man and the switch.
And Christian Moxis, just before that, gets a score of 61.9, Christian Moxis, and this is the rerun of what we've just seen.
Here we go. Let's look for that hand to touch the water. A lot of power.
Great view from the front here. Yeah, there's the blind man. Switchblade.
Given the visa.
He was given the great sign of and diving into the water at the end. Wow, he's enjoying it, ladies and gentlemen.
Look at that smile on his face.
Big smile on his face. Incredible. I thought he was going to cling on to the end of the platform. I didn't think he was going to slide off. It looked like he got it nailed, and then he just kind of turned to the left, dives off into the water with a big smile on his face as well. Don't go anywhere. Still to come, we have the overnight leader, Nick Batch. He is out of the helicopter now. We are going to see his boomerang Superman and hopefully get him on to the platform too. It's an incredible day of live action. We had the practice round. It was incredible. The sky opened, we had the sunshine, and we've got a sunshine now. It's all lined up to be a fantastic extreme final round of action here in Swoop Challenge 2016. Irish, over to you, and Claudio Cagnazzo.
We are down here now with Claudio. Give it up, Swoop Challenge for Claudio! He is walking up the stage now, strutting it up. Come on up here, Claudio. We've got Nicholas up there, so we're going to make this quick. I do have some good news for you. You just put down the second biggest score of the day. You must be happy with that one.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy. Not the best performance. I kind of got the raft, but got one more round to go, man.
Beautiful, mate. We will see you in round two. Good luck. You can take the title out. Back to you guys in the studio for Nick.
Very much there, Claudio. 75.7. Second place on round one. Now the overnight leader, Nick Batch, team alter ego, line himself up.
Here we go, left hand 810, first 360, and he's got one more 360 to do. Ooh. Going into a boomerang Superman. So coming in with the carve, looking to touch the water, there we go, and then leaning forward in the harness, there we go, there's a Superman popping it up. Is he going to stand it up? He stood it up! Incredible for Nick Bash!
I don't think we've ever actually seen that before. Incredible. For the first time live ever at Swoop Challenge, standing up into the middle of the platform, Nick Butch.
What an incredible performance from Nick. That was just poetry in motion to see. He's got to be so chuffed with that.
Here comes the replay.
Let's check it out. Okay. Great boomerang there. Look, and forward right in the harness, looking like Superman, popping it up, just looking relaxed. Yeah, I'm going to stand it up. Boom, one or two steps.
Incredible.
Just like a gymnast.
Have you ever seen anything like that before? The calm, the cool action from Nick Butch as he fires up his fist over to the VIP section. Irish, over to you.
Give it up for Nick Butch. Absolutely fantastic. Nick, that is your signature move. You brought it here. The first person ever in Swoop Challenge to stand it up on the pontoon. How are you feeling?
I feel amazing. I'm telling you what, cloud nine, don't know what to say. Just absolutely exhilarating experience.
This has got to put you in the standing for biggest score. That's going to bring you into the second round. Is that added pressure going into the second round, knowing that it's all up to you to bring it home?
You know, I'm having a lot of fun out here, and that's what it's all about, is the people in the crowd. So hopefully the next move will go just as well as that one, and I'm looking forward to having some fun. So let's go knock it out, and I hope the nerves don't get to me. Hopefully it'll help me out.
You keep pulling moves out like that, this crowd is going to lose their mind. Thank you very much, Nick. Best of luck for the rest of the competition.
Thank you, Irish. You're great.
Beautiful. Nick Butch there with one of the best jumps we've seen. Back to you guys in the studio.
Oh, wow. We haven't got the score of Nick Butch. I can't believe that. We need to know what that score was. It was an incredible thing. I've never seen anything like that. Middle of the pontoon. Great shots here over the lake of Pebblingersoll. Look at those gorgeous sky. It's open as it should be for the Swoop Challenge competition. Foggy, well, tell me what you made of that from Nick Butch.
Well, that was just incredible. It's one of the first times I've seen such skill and being able to stand up, you know, on that slippy pontoon. Just incredible.
Beautiful views here now. I've just been told we're still waiting for the score. The judges have not decided yet how they're going to score it, because they've never seen anything like it before in their lives. It's absolutely incredible. Great shots of the crowds. Hundreds of thousands of people here this afternoon for the Swoop Challenge final. We have got a wingsuit display for you coming up very shortly indeed, and I'll be handing over to Irish, who's going to talk us through that. But in the meantime, Nick Butch there, look at the smile on his face. Look at how relieved he is. Travis just at the side. Incredible. He picks up. He's got the head shake going on. He can't believe what he's just done. And there is his score, 75.1. 75.1. So it's not the biggest we've seen. The best score so far goes to Lee Barraclough, 77.8 for his double brown. Can you believe it? Nick Butch, 75.1 there. We've got 2 minutes until we get the wingsuits above us. What do you make of that, Foggy?
Well, that's great. I mean, I was expecting maybe a little bit of a higher score for Nicholas Butch there, but amazing effort from Lee Barraclough, and he's got to be so happy that he's in first place now.
But look, we've got the scores we've got now, the results so far. We've got Nick Butch in the lead on... So that was the overnight scores. Do apologise for that. Nick Butch there, that was only a 4.8 multiplier, wasn't it? Now we've got the scores. The current standings after that one round of finals. In the lead with 7.8 points, Lee Barraclough. Second place, Claudio Casnazio, 75.72. Third, Nick Butch slipping down from his first place, 75.12. Kurt Bartholomew in fourth with 74.95. Fifth place, David Junior, 71. Six, Gage Galley, 67.41. Seven, Christian Moxner, 61.97. 8, Travis Mills, 61.92. 9, Tom Baker, 61.50. 10th, Chris Stewart, 57.11. 11th, place right now after one round. One more round to go. Reese Kempton, 57.06. Jeannie Bartholomew, 54.06. Noah Banson, 13th place, 51.33. 14th, Christian Weber, 46. 15th place, Ian Bobo, 45.99. 6th place, Timmy Thompson, 41.90. We're going over to Irish before we go to the final round for a wingsuit display.
Yes, thank you very much, Regan. I am coming out here to see how the crowd is enjoying it. Copenhagen, are you enjoying Swoop Challenge? Listen to that cheer. We are having such a great time. We have got four wingsuiters in the air right now. If you put your eyes to the sky, you can see the plane. This is the Danish swingsuit team. They're going to fly from the bottom of the lake all the way past. You will see four little dots in the air and smoke coming off their feet. These are the best in the world. We've all seen it on YouTube. We've seen it all over the world. Now you're going to see it live here at Copenhagen at Swoop Challenge. Guys, unbelievable first round. I cannot believe it. We have got Dummy here. Dummy, please tell me what it's like being a judge out there.
It's the best seat on the house.
Amazing, you guys are doing an absolutely fantastic job. What are you expecting for round two?
A lot of good surprise, I hope.
Beautiful, and you're a wingsuiter yourself, Tommy. Would you be able to explain some of the stuff that's going to be happening with these guys?
I think they're going to be jumping with smokes, so you're going to be able to see their path in the sky very well. They're going to fly a formation, so basically it's flying as tight as possible together.
Beautiful, we just got the boat coming in here now. We're getting the rest of the... Getting the rest of the judges coming now. Okay, yeah, sweet, awesome. So we're going to get confirmation when the wingsuiters are dropping. So these guys are wearing big wingsuits so that they can fly and fly and fly. The world record at the moment is 35 kilometers under a wingsuit, which is incredible. But once again, guys, everyone on the far side, are you having a good time? Give me a wave! Beautiful. Everyone on the bridge, how are you doing out there? Everyone on the bridge, give me a wave! Oh, I reckon we can get a cheer out of you. Give me a cheer on the bridge. 3, 2, 1! Awesome, we got the VIP over here. Hello, guys. Okay, let's get our eyes to the sky. We've got wingsuiters out. They are exiting from 10,000 feet. They are going to be doing 220 kilometers an hour vertical. As you can see, the two dots in the air, look at them flying above us. Directly above us, look straight up now, Copenhagen. We have got the wingsuiters cruising past. 220 kilometers an hour vertically and going straight. As you can see, the smoke coming out the back. We do have some wingsuiters coming behind them, chasing up from behind. They are going to go land somewhere else. They're going to pull the parachutes at 4,000 feet. So keep an eye on it. Collapsing the big suit, giving the parachute all the chance to come out. Looking really good. Can we please give it up for the wingsuiters? Beautiful, guys. Thank you so much. All their parachutes are open. They're looking safe. They're going to go land somewhere and they're going to come back and see us. Guys, we have finished round one. We are going into round two and the scoreboard could not be tighter. This is the competition you want to watch. Last year, it finished with 0.8 of a difference. This year, we're expecting the same with the guys on top of the ladder. As you can see, parachute opening there. Nice, safe opening. He's going to be come back, and they're going to be in the VIP later on.
Not landing here.
Yeah.
Beautiful, guys. So, round two coming up now. As you can see, the weather has dropped off. It is perfect for skydiving now. Nil wind. We've got the boat guys out here having a great time. What is the atmosphere like in the middle of the pond?
Ecstatic.
You can hear the crowd. Everyone's going crazy.
Yes, we can.
Beautiful. You're doing a great job out there, guys. Please don't run anyone over.
Well, what an incredible afternoon we are having here. We've just had those wingsuits flying across down the lake. Incredible sight, really, to see live. I'm sure the people here absolutely loved it. That first round, what a controversial, incredible live-action performance we saw at the end there. Nick Batch coming through with his turn and standing up on the middle of the platform. Not enough, though, to take him into first place overall right now after one round. Lee Barraclough, tell us about what he did, Foggy.
Well, Lee, on his last one, on the second round, he was doing his signature move. So it's the double brown, which we love to see. It's swooping over the water, dinking the leg in, dragging the water, and then popping up, grabbing his leg in his hand, and then the other one as well, both at the same time, landed on the pontoon as well. Great to see him. First place, well done, Lee.
An incredible performance coming all the way from New Zealand and showing everybody how it's done. One more round to go, and Lee Barraclough, Leroy Brown, is in first position. Round two is coming up very shortly. It can only get better. Look at behind us. Look at the sky. It's clear and open. A few scattered clouds, very, very high. This is Swoop Challenge Live, brought to you from here, Copenhagen. Peb Lee. So what we're going to be getting now on our next round, let's see what we've got. Go, Chris Stewart is going to be starting us off, and what we'll get from Stewart, we get a wing.
We're going to get a wing over. We haven't seen one of these yet, maybe in the practice round, but a wing over, very, very tricky trick to do. Basically, he'll be coming over after the turn, he's doing a 630 degree turn, coming through the course, and then carving round, but actually while he's dragging the water with his foot, trying to put one of the edges of the parachute into the water itself. Now that's so dangerous to do, because if you grab too much, boom, you're in the water. So it's a little dink, try and hold it there as long as possible, get it back and fly it onto the pontoon, but very, very tricky.
And here we are live in the chopper. That is Chris Stewart about to go into round two. Ladies and gentlemen, here around the lake, look at what you're watching. All the congratulations, the high fives. They know it's all to play for now. Chris is placing his goggles. Look at the look of concentration on his face. We are watching, can you believe it, live action from the helicopter as Chris prepares himself. He doesn't know that you can all see him. 100,000 people down here and millions worldwide are watching this. Chris Stewart opening up the final round of Swoop Challenge 2016. I can't believe we've got here already. It seems like we've only just started 2 minutes ago. We're already to the final. I want to go into another competition next week. I can't wait another year. Don't do this to me. It's not fair on anybody. Chris Stewart fastens his chin strap. Everybody, Christian Weber from Denmark there, just rubbing his hands at concentration. Christian Weber's second, Ian Bobo, then Jeannie Bartholomew. Don't dangle that child too far over the bridge. We're not going to be falling in. I hope you're having a great time here, everybody. The sun is starting to set, but we've still got enough light. Clap your hands if you're having a good time. That's what that little kid's saying there. Chris Stewart, New Zealand. This is incredible, Foggy.
This is incredible. The light looks like it's going down a little bit. It's still fine for the jumping conditions, though. But we may be able to see the helicopter in the sky now. I don't know.
He's able to look up. Can you see it? Can you see that helicopter up there somewhere? First person to spot it wins a prize from your parents. Like, he's looking up there over to the end of the North Station. There it is, moving over, catching the sun, glinting. You can see from the ground the helicopter turning round to the right. You can see in the air that Chris Stewart has opened the door. He's looking down at us. Give him a wave, everybody. Shout to him. Give him a wave. It's Chris Stewart up there rubbing his hands. Feels a little bit chilly. It's game on. Ian Bobo says, good luck. He turns on his GoPro camera. It's a choice of cameras for all skydivers and canopy pilots worldwide. Eyes on the prize. He knows he needs to bring something big. His GoPro is flashing. That means he's good to go. He checks his altitude, checks his deployment system, gives a thumbs up to all his mates, gets his left foot out of the door. He's just looking at the spot. He wants to be in the right place. Eyeballing it now. He's getting his body out. This is it. This is what it looks like to leave a helicopter at 7,000 feet, ladies and gentlemen. Woohoo! Says Chris. He's gone. Wow! Into free fall, going down 80, 90, 100 miles an hour, then opens his parachute. And the door gets shut by Christian Weber. Wow, this is incredible action to have it live feed from the helicopter down to people here today. All the people there in the VIP, are you all okay? Having a good time? Yeah, people on the bridge from the studio, hello! On the far side, we know we love you. You're far, far away, but we love you more because of that. Hello, people on the far side. And then looking down here from the studio, Foggy, people are lined up all day. Can you give us a cheer, everybody? We'll catch you on the microphone. Give us a cheer. 3, 2, 1. Yes. and all the way down this side of the lake as well, there's people all queued up. We couldn't ask for anything better than this. It is the finals, the conditions are great. We've got Dan Escarbladi next to us as well, giving their live feed. We've got Iris doing the interviews. Are you okay there, Iris? Gives me a big fist pump. He's ready for the party later as well. Hundreds and hundreds of people have put everything together to make this event happen. We are live to the world and live to the people of Copenhagen right now. Chris Stewart, over to you, Fog, as he starts his run.
Okay, so yeah, Chris is just on his setup now, just testing the winds. From the ground, I can just feel a little bit of a push onto the course, maybe a tiny little bit of a downwind. So he needs to be making sure that he sets up quite far back. There's either be zero wind or a little bit of a downwind push. So onto the deep brakes now. Well, what turn is he going to do? Left hand 630, and then he wants to be dipping that wing in the water there. Pretty dangerous move to do. Let's see how he does. Taking it through the course, swinging it around for the power, letting the canopy recover.
Oh, heavy
impact.
What
a big crash.
Heavy impact for Chris into
the
water. He's giving the double thumbs up. He's fine. What a shame, all the anticipation. You've competed, Foggy, you know what it's like. You've got to wait at the airport, you've got to get your flight up to the top. It's all over in seconds, and if you get a bad one like that, it must be so disheartening.
It is, especially when you've been waiting for a long time. There's only due to the weather restrictions, you've only got a few jumps, you know, to perform. And even those jumps yesterday, they had to be qualifying jumps. So very tricky for the guys to actually perform. They haven't warmed up so well. Just unlucky, really, on his part. I'm glad he's okay.
And it shows as well how all these parachutes, they do dive heavily to the ground.
Incredible speed they can pick up to, well, anywhere between sort of 95 and 110 miles an hour.
We're back in the helicopter there with a shot of Christian Webber and Ian Bobo. They don't know what they've just seen. Nick, Chris is just rubbing his neck there. I think he's, you know, his neck feels a bit sore. He'll know about that tomorrow. Making his way back on the pontoon. Ladies and gentlemen, please go and give him the biggest round of applause you've ever had. Finishing off his competition here, not his best round, he's giving you a big wave as well. This is what it's all about, the sportsmanship. Chris Stewart, we watched you all the way, man. We had you live in the helicopter, and we had you exit, beautiful exit, must say, by the way. Great job, Chris Stewart. And now, live on the camera, Christian Webber, eyeballs down to the ground. He is where Chris Stewart was just a few moments ago. This is what it all comes down to, ladies and gentlemen, the exit and the performance. I'm going to go over to Irish and his chat with Chris Stewart.
Chris Stewart, going out with a bang, literally. Talk us through what went wrong on that jump and why you impacted the water.
The canopy, I don't know, I'm not going to blame anything. I just cracked, I guess, under the pressure. The canopy definitely did not like the turn, being jumped that wet. But that's part of the game, man. I'm fine. I've lost a GoPro. It's all good. It's just part of it. It's no big deal.
I seen you were wearing sunnies. Does that play a factor now that it's got a little bit darker up there?
No, not so much at all. Just when your gear's that wet, man, it just... I'm not going to blame that. I just made a mistake. It was a rookie mistake, man. I just messed up. It's not
cool. Last jump of the event. How do you feel being here in Denmark? How's this Denmark crowd?
I mean, the crowd's awesome. Thank you very much for coming out, guys. I mean, I would have loved to have done a better job than that, but that's just what you get sometimes, you know? Just messed up.
We still love you, Chris. Get back in there. Back to you in the studio, guys.
Oh, well, terrible that for Chris Stewart. You can feel the emotion in him. And 22.37 was his score. Matt, he's talking about the canopy being wet. It does make a difference to the flight, doesn't it?
It does make a difference to the flight, and especially the opening. So, it is quite pretty difficult for the guys to be packing wet gear and then opening in wet gear as well. Usually the opening isn't particularly nice for these guys. It can be quite hard.
Right.
So starting up from the beginning, not very good. And again, flying pretty different as well in wet conditions, wet canopies.
Well,
just
next
unfortunate.
Up, Christian Webber from Denmark, local talent. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a multiplier of 5.2 on his Lazy Ghost Rider and a turn of 450. Fat Moggy.
Fat Moggy.
Foggity. Foggity, over to you.
Okay, so he's on to deep breaks. Get you back, Regan.
Thank you.
Going for the dive now to left hand 450. Nice and smooth, nice and slow, building up the speed nice and smoothly. Stopping there a little bit, maybe he'll be just down on that, but nice whip round, bang on course for the for the pontoon.
Oh,
he's got the guns out and he slipped onto the pontoon.
Yes. Incredible! Christian Weber, lazy boy, amazing, nailed it. Ghost Rider, nailed it. Arms to the side, to the judges, to all the people of Denmark, onto the platform as well. Does it get any better than that?
That
check out
just
the arms.
Incredible from Christian. All the Danish people must be very proud of him right now. Good turn. Let's watch for those guns.
Check out the attitude at the end. First of all, the lazy boy absolutely nails
right
it.
Back in the heart.
Boom!
And he keeps it going all the way.
Wow. Brilliant people stuff. Of Denmark, what do you make of that? Here's a slow-mo from the, I think it's from the front camera angle. We'll get a nice shot here of those guns, Foggy.
Some great photographs of that.
Here it is.
I think he's trying to shoot us.
Boom!
Just wonderful stuff. So relaxed, just skimming across the surface of the water there. He knows he's done well. Massive smile on his face.
Incredible! Bringing it home from Denmark for Irish. Go for it.
Please give it up for Christian Weber! Christian, you got the Danish cannons out. You pointed at the judges saying, hey, I'm here, let's do this, give me the points. How do you feel after that?
I'm so happy now. That was the move I have planning for, and I'm so happy I made it.
You executed it brilliantly. You gave the crowd what they wanted. The competition's over for you now, but that score puts you right in contention.
Yeah, I hope it'll help me for the first round. So, are we ready to see the score?
Thank you very much. The Danish, please give it up for the local man, Christian Weber!
Well, a great score there, 71.6 in round two for Weber. 71.6 for Weber there, just for that 40 points for the first round. But wow, what an incredible second round for Weber. What did you make of that?
Wow, that was just incredible. We all saw so smooth over the water, just giving the guns to us, I think, to show us that he's doing well and doing it for Denmark.
This is Swoop Challenge live to the world and to 100,000 people here in Copenhagen around this lake at Peblinger. So we are incredibly excited about what's happening right now. The atmosphere around is electric. Everywhere is full. The bridge is full. The VIP is full. Of course, the VIP is full. Out here on the platform, it's full as well. Hello, you guys. On the other side of the lake, everybody's down there. It's good to see you and all our friends here behind the studio. It's good to be with you as well, guys. Thanks for joining us. Next up's going to be Ian Bobo. He's there in the door right now, Matt. He's going to leave, and there he is out. Oh, no, it's a replay. He's actually about to start his turn.
Okay, so Bobo's ready to start his turn. He's over the target now on deep brakes, just waiting for that final point, taking the pressure out of the canopy now. Watch his arms as he brings the front of the canopy down. Let's just increase the speed, leaning into the left hand side. He's going to be doing a 630 degree turn, so another 360 now. He's going to go for a wing over, dipping that wing tip in the edge of the water. Let's see whether he can do it nicely across the water. He's got the wing tip in.
Oh!
He's flying it.
Come on,
oh, he's touched the pontoon as well. I think that would be pretty good.
Five, yeah.
At least 2.5.
Yeah.
Great
number
there.
Just on the end. He wanted to be on that podium platform so much. His canopy's on there. He was just reaching for it. He wasn't happy with his round one. He wasn't happy with his round one of the finals at all, but that was a better move. That wing over looked nice for him.
It did look very nice. Great. He's got it in and he's got back up and then managed to fly it all the way to the pontoon. Unfortunately, it was just, if he had been maybe a meter forward,
yeah,
he would have popped on nicely.
Oh man, I thought he was going to be on that. I thought he was going to slide right onto it there.
Me too.
Let's check out that wing over again. It's a nice move.
It's a nice move. Just caught his elbow on the water that turned to the left, yeah, make him bounce and then back into the water. Maybe if he didn't catch that, he would have had the momentum. But I think he's going to be happier with that round than the previous one for sure.
Well, we hope so. We're going to get his score on the screen very shortly. He's powering his way back now to the Wibbly Wobbly Bridge, where he's going to be met by our co-host, Peter Irish Sutton.
Thank you very much, Regan, for that great intro. We've got Ian Bobo coming up the ramp now. He has got to be happy with that one. Wasn't happy with his first one, but coming in with a great wing over, flying the wing on the water, which is incredible, because once that canopy gets wet, it wants to dive in, but he flew it anyway. Oh, having a bit of trouble getting off the pontoon, had a bit of trouble getting on the pontoon. They're not his friends today. Come on up here, Ian Bobo. crowd, give it up for Ian Bobo! He's got a big smile on his face. Come on up here, Ian. Just nearly made it to the pontoon. I seen your hand out there reaching like Romeo and Juliet. You wanted it so bad. You must be happy with that one after your first round performance.
I think I got the wing on the water. I'm pretty sure. That was the best one of the meet so far. Saved it for last.
Yeah, you're going out with a bang. Absolutely fantastic. How has the event been for you so far?
Incredible. I mean, world class for sure. Definitely proud to be a part of it. And
Okay, sorry, we need to go back to the studio now. Back to the studio. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Jeannie Bartholomew is somewhere in the sky. Oh, she's here in the helicopter. I believe this is now, just checking, it is live. It is live, look at her there, that big smile of Jeannie Bartholomew. Nothing ever phases her. She's always happy and ready to participate in this amazing world-class event. Balancing in the edge of the door. GoPro is on. It is a replay we're watching in the screen now of the exit. There is the exit. She's just setting up above the lake. You just saw her exit. Mark, go for it.
Okay, so yeah, Jeannie's just about to set up for a 450 left hand. She's going to be doing that lazy girl switchblade cowboy. So leaning right back, putting those the control toggles into one hand, trying to fly the canopy, and then putting the other hand in the water. So let's see whether she can do it. It looks like a good turn. Maybe a little bit of high. She's going for it. Oh! She's got it. She's touched the pontoon as well.
I thought she was going to slide up there. Jeannie Bartholomew with a lazy girl, a switchblade and cowgirl. Still smiling.
Definitely. It looks like she got the lazy girl there and the switchblade. So let's see whether she got the cowboy.
Wearing a lot of weight as well. She's competing against these big guys. She has to wear a lot of weight to compensate.
That's it. She's a light girl, so to keep the speed, they wear a weight belt, especially Jeannie. So it's important that these boat guys get out there quick, which they're doing a great job today. So she's leading right back, got both toggles in her hand. I think she touched down on the cowboy as well, so she'll be extremely pleased with that round.
Those tricks were great.
Brilliant.
Excellent tricks from Jeannie Bartholomew. She's on the boat now. There's this front view. We'll get a good view of the switchblade.
Here we go. So leading right back, there's the switchblade and the touch. Putting the left hand toggle down, the controls, to try and pull her back onto the pontoon. Unfortunately, the canopy just tied to the right a bit too quick.
Wow, incredible action. She's there on the boat. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, as she makes her way over to the bridge. Punch in the air, the big white smile of Jeannie Bartholomew, Team Alter Ego. Just gathering her stuff together. Next up's going to be David Jr. We're going to go to Irish for a chat.
Yes, I'm down here waiting for Jeannie. Crowd, girls, everybody, give it up for Jeannie Bartholomew! An absolute crowd favorite, inspiration for women everywhere. You're here showing the boys how it's done. You must be happy with that. You've had two great rounds. Last year wasn't your year. This year is definitely your year. How do you feel after all this?
I'm feeling really good. That was awesome. It's a beautiful sunset up there. I got down on the water and nailed my move. Almost got to the raft. So yeah, I'm super happy with that.
Jeannie, anything you'd like to say to all girls out there that want to get into skydiving, anything you'd like to say to them?
Go for it. You can do it, ladies. Woo!
Girl power, back to you in the studio.
Great job there from Jeannie with 58.3, giving her a total of 112.4 and Foggy.
Wonderful. Well, now we've got Junior, and this is the one to watch, one of a big one. It's the biggest turn out of all the competitors, a right-hand 1080. And what he's going to be doing is twisting in the harness, a full 360 before he starts that move. Well, that's what he's got written down on the paper, and then he's going to go into a Miracle Man, full 360 unwinding, and then a Ghost Rider, taking his hands off the controls and putting them in the water.
So he hasn't gone for that twist?
He hasn't gone for the twist on this one. Looks like, let's see what he's going to pull out. Okay. So he's gone for a Ghost Rider, crossing the arms as well. Looking cool as he's skimming over the water there.
It looked like a Ghost Rider Superman combination.
Let's have a look.
David Jr. before with that twist. Here he is, being followed on camera as well.
Well, it didn't work out for him quite well on the previous round, that twist. So maybe he just made a bit of an adjustment. But looking cool over the water, look at that. Trying to get those rear rises to pop him, keep him flying up until the pontoon. Don't think he quite had the lift or a little bit too far back, but nice and smooth over the water.
Yeah, came third last year. David Junior Ludwig. Just before that, just repeat, Genie's score 5.8.3 for Genie in that second round. Before that, Ian Bobo 6.6.9. Christian Weber 7.1.6. Before that, Chris Stewart 2.2.37. This is finals live action, the final round of the competition here in Copenhagen for Swoop Challenge 2016. Great shot there of Junior just crashing down just before the podium. He's on the boat. In fact, he's off the boat. Over to you, Irish.
The most relaxed man at Swoop Challenge. Arms crossed, coming in like he was going to a business meeting. Junior, come on up here. But Junior, you left the twist out. Is that because of the performance in round one?
Yeah, I just wanted to make sure it's safe. We always safety first. And with that last one being the first one doing it in competition, I just wanted to make sure we were safe for the city here in Copenhagen and also for myself. And my lovely lady is over here somewhere, Nicole. She would have probably killed me if I would have hurt myself, so.
I know there have been a lot of people worried out there about you. How's the Copenhagen? How's it been so far for you, the whole event?
Oh, man, every time I come to the city, it gets better and better. Last year was amazing. This year's even better. The crowd here is awesome. Fighting through the weather, coming out here both days, it's been amazing.
Beautiful. Thank you very much, Junior. We'll see you guys later on. Back to you in the studio.
Very much, guys. 6.2.8 score there for Junior. 6.2.8. Give him a total right now of 1.33.8. So that's good score there. 1.33.8 total after these two rounds, and a second round score is 6.2.8. Foggy.
Okay, we've got Reese in the air. Reese Kempen from New Zealand doing it for the Kiwis like Lee Barraclough. He's going to be doing a big turn, left 810 degree turn, maximum score of 10 points for that turn. So let's see how he does. And he's going to be going for another wing over. So dipping that wing tip in the water. It's a great trick to see because it's quite tense. You never know whether they're going to be going in the water or not. So let's keep our fingers crossed. He can keep it flying, keep it powerful, and get on that pontoon. Right, okay, so he's still in his setup.
Yeah, his score in his first round was 5.7.1. 5.7.1 was his first round score. So he needs something good now to improve on that to get himself up the standings.
Well, this wing over should give him a 5.4 multiplier. So if he can do it well and get a good landing, I know his turn's good. So he should be pretty confident with that one. And a combination should give him a good overall score.
In deep bricks now, looking down over this beautiful evening setting of pebbling or so. He's got the platform in his eyes.
He's coming down on his downwind leg now, basically just checking out the wind. These guys have got different points in the sky before they start the turn to help them get in the right place. So it looks like he's coming onto his final. He's starting the turn now. This is a big 8-10 degree turn over the buildings. Last 360, a lot of speed on that turn, letting the canopy pan out. Let's see whether we can get that wingtip in the water. He's got it in. He's flying it. He's got it in. Unfortunately, didn't land on the pontoon, but pretty close.
Reese Kempen there, New Zealand with a left 8.10 and looking for that wing over with a multiplier of 5.4. First round score, 5.7.1. And look at that beautiful picture there, the sun setting down on the other side of the lake. Absolutely gorgeous. The architecture here in Copenhagen is incredible. Beautiful. Here's a slow motion, Foggy.
Here we go, Reese. Right, nice and smooth in the turn, I think. Keeping it going, building that power, getting faster and faster into that final point. Eyeing up the course and the pontoon now. He's coming over, it looks like he's putting it in, looking at that wingtip to make sure it's in. I think it went in a little bit too far. Just pulled him down into the water there. Great contact with his leg on the water though. Hit the surface of the water with his elbow. I think that might have been a contribution as well. But knowing Reese, he's going to have a big, fat smile on his face. I can see it from here. Well done, Reese.
There he is, just making his way to the end of the bridge in front of all these amazing crowd here in Copenhagen, and a spontaneous applause breaks out over on the left-hand side of the bridge. Over to you, Irish.
Look at that smile. Give it up for Reese Kempen! We have seen that smile all week. It hasn't come off your face. You're one of the athlete's favourites. You're one of the crowd favourites. Philip, the whole experience for you is Swoop Challenge.
Oh, it's been amazing. It's hard to get that smile off your face in an experience like this, mate. It's awesome. Getting wet. Awesome.
Getting wet. So you came in there, were you worried about the buildings? You were right over there.
No, they weren't sort of in front of me on my line of flight, so I wasn't too worried about that. Might have looked pretty freaky from here, but it looked all right for me.
There's a few people holding their breath. Reese, thank you so much for everything. Yeah, we'll see you guys next year. Kiwis can fly. Back to you in the studio.
Nice one, Pete. Still waiting for that score from Reese there. 5-1 point, 5-7 point 1 was his score in the first round. Let's find out what he's got in the second round. As soon as I know, I'll let you know. There's the shot of this course for his Swoop challenge over the bridge. And over to you, Foggy, with Noah Banson.
Okay, so Noah from the USA is going to be doing another big turn, 8-10 on deep brakes now, and going in for a boomerang and a miracle man. So getting that carve, putting that foot in the water as he carves around, and then miracle man is a 360 degree flip in the harness. So let's see what goes on here. Into the turn now, swinging it around, big rotations from Noah. Looks like he's got a lot of speed as well. In all the way around, he's wonderful, what a great trick.
Incredible, I thought he was going to stay there.
I did as well, so smooth around in the Miracle Man as well, and his approach. I think he thought he was going to stay on and stick on as well, but just plopped off the end.
The beginning of his trick was so smooth, it was like he was just stepping off a curb. Watch this, there it is.
Flying the canopy.
There's a Miracle Man.
All the way without seeing where he's going. Skidding along, trying to hold on with his fingernails, I think. All the way to the end, unfortunate. But what a great performance from Noah there.
And watch how long at the end, once he's on, the beautiful tricks, a miracle man, there, and here he is now. He's got his eyes on the podium. We can see that he's trying to stop. Oh, man. Noah, last year's champion, last year's winner.
He's everybody's champion.
Yeah, 51.3 was his score in round one, Foggy. Let's see what he's going to get there.
Well, I think he's going to beat that for sure.
Yeah.
Because he's got solid turn, solid time over the water, flying that canopy without even looking where he's going, and bang on the pontoon, the line of the pontoon there. He wasn't off a degree, just had a little bit too much power.
Well, he's making his way off the boat, and he's going to get his interview with Peterson.
I've got Noah Banson coming up now, last year's champion. That's what we like to see from a miracle man boomerang right onto the podium. Just came off the end there. Some would say too much power through that turn, but you did an absolutely fantastic job. Are you happy with the way you have finished Swoop Challenge?
Yeah, I'm super stoked with that, man. The tail would not stop fluttering. There's something wrong with the parachute, man. With it being wet, the last two jumps is just killing all the speed, but that was good. I'm happy with it.
Still did a fantastic job coming in there. Did you think you were going to stay on?
No, I could feel it.
Awesome, thank you so much for this year. Noah, your score's on the scoreboard now. Back to you guys in the studio.
Well, a great score there. The best one so far this evening. 8-1.8 from Noah Banson. Next up, Gage Galley.
Okay, so Gage, he's showing you a couple of barrel rolls there that he's did last year, I think, over the water. This one he's going to be doing a left-hand 630-degree turn, maximum of 8 points, and then going for a blind man switchblade in, and he's going to try and land that switchblade right on the pontoon itself. So that's flying the canopy with just one arm, with both control toggles in one hand, landing on the pontoon.
Just to repeat there, we've got Noah on 8-1.8 with a total of 133.1. Just behind Junior on 133.8. Here's the Gage Galley.
Okay, so swinging it around now, we're looking for a blind man. So 180 degrees in the harness, and then that swap to toggles. He's got the 180, he's got it.
Oh!
He's flying. Oh! Tried to land it with the toggles in his hand, flew it very nicely, but just slipped off the edge. It's so difficult to stay on that pontoon.
There's a lot of water on there now. Me and Irish went out there earlier. It was ankle deep in water. My feet are still absolutely soaking. So here we go. Here's a replay. Gage Galley.
Okay, so great turn from Gage. Lovely and smooth. Nice and vertical, so a lot of power. He always comes out with a lot of power on his turns. It's brilliant to see. Relaxed over the water. Nice blind man, and then swapping those toggles into one hand, flying the canopy. Can feel it going over to the left, but pulls his hand over to the right. I think it pulls his even more over to the left accidentally. Wonderful. correcting, I think he was off course then, and actually corrected it without looking where he was going. He wasn't going to make the pontoon, bank the canopy over to the left while he was looking the other way. It was just incredible. That just comes with massive amount of experience.
Yeah. Well, David Jr., there we go, after two rounds, 133.8, and Noah Banson after two rounds, 133.1. So they're the two highest so far after the second round. We've still got lots more big hitters to come. The biggest one from round one, Lee Barraclough, 77.8, is going to be next. What we're going to see from him, we'll find out very shortly. In the meantime, it's time for Gage Galley to get his interview with Peter Harris Sutton.
Gage Galley, the only man in the world who can bring back the mullet and speed stripes. Absolutely fantastic performance. He's been talking about the hair all week. I've seen some kids walking around with the mullet. He's bringing it back. Gage, come on up, mate. You've had a great swoop challenge, finished with an absolutely fantastic jump. Just came off at the end there, but you must be happy with your performance on that one, coming in last jump of the round.
Yeah, absolutely, man. It's been all business up to this point, but it's time to party.
Yeah, so do you want to show everyone at home what type of party we're talking about? There you go. There it is, flowing in the wind, and we got the speed stripes up the side. Gage, you've had a great time here at Cope Swoop Challenge?
Yeah, absolutely, man.
Fantastic. Man of short words. Back to you in the studio.
Thank you very much, Ari. 71.3 score there for Gage Galley, giving him a tied total from his first round of 67.4, a new lead of 138.7. So Gage Galley halfway through the pack, currently looking at the top. Here's Lee Barraclough.
Lee Barraclough, number one in round two. So he's going to do 8.10. He's coming in just for a cowboy. If he can keep this smooth, he's going to keep his lead. That's a lovely cowboy. Keep it flying. Missed his toggle, unfortunately, just before the pontoon. He almost had, he's got his toggle around his head. Is he okay? Can you give us a hands up? Lee.
Yeah, he's fine.
There we go.
See him there. Well.
Oh, unfortunate for Lee, but what a lovely cowboy. It was a great move.
How's that going to affect his score? He was in the lead after the first round of the finals with 77.8. Gage Galley had a 67.4. He just put down a 71.3. Remember, this is out of 100. Maximum 100 points. Here's a slow motion for you, Foggy.
Okay, here we go. Great turn from Lee. Always confident on his turn. 66 square foot parachute, this is.
Wow.
Lovely over the water, nice and confident, flying it straight in. Just missed his toggle on the recovery,
yeah.
And then just turned the canopy right into the water then. He's got to be disappointed, but I think he'll be very happy with the... I missed his riser.
Yeah.
So difficult, the canopy's wet, the risers are wet.
Yeah, yeah.
You're traveling along the ground probably 60 kilometers an hour.
That was a great shot there to show that missed grab, wasn't it? Here he is, back to the platform. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Lee Barraclough, Leroy Brown.
Leroy Brown.
Here comes Lee. Here comes Lee now, the leading person coming up now. Lee, Swoop Challenge, it's been fantastic. You've proved to everyone in the world that New Zealand knows how to skydive. You're showing the world how to do it. How do you feel, buddy?
I feel pretty good, man, but I didn't get onto that pontoon, but cowboy was money. Yeah, happy days, man. SDK all day. Woo!
You just dropped a toggle there. Did you feel it coming out of your hand while you were coming in?
Yeah, so I just popped a Ghost Rider at the end, throw it in there. Didn't write it down, but happy days, man.
Just looking for extra points out of the judges. You've already been judged, but thank you so much. You're a crowd favourite, Lee. Give it up for Lee Barraclough.
Cheers, man.
Thank you very much, Lee. 56.9. So not a big score there for Lee. That's going to hurt from his first round performance of 77.8. That gives him a 134.7 total right now. Beautiful vanilla sky above us. And we've got Timmy Thompson coming next, who did a 41.9. Looking down the list, though, we had Travis Mills with a 61, Stormo 62, Kurt Bartholomew 74, nearly 75, Claudio and Nick Batch are both in the mid-70s, Foggy.
Yeah, they are, and Timmy's coming up very soon. He's going to be doing a left 450, so an accurate turn, a little bit lower than the other guys, maybe scoring a little bit lower,
yeah.
But if he can keep it accurate, it's better chance to get on the pontoon. He's then going to be straight into a blind man switchblade cowboy, so turning 180 degree in the harness, flipping those control toggles over into one hand, flying the canopy with the one hand, and then dipping his hand into the water as well. It's a big scoring move. It's going to multiply it by 5.9 if he can pull this off.
It's a big scoring move for the trick. The turn's not big. He needs to land it. He's got to be on the podium.
Yeah, really.
He's got to be on the platform, hasn't he, for a good score. He only got 41.9 in the first round, so he needs to pull something special out of the bag. But do you know what? If anybody can do it, Timmy Thompson can. Local boy, Danish crowd, here is your man. Go wild. Foggy, take it over.
Okay, here we go. Looks like he's going to start his turn right now. So he's into the left-hand 90, and then we're looking for another 360. Speeding it up, stopping a little bit. It's going to dink his score with the judges, I think. On target, though, it looks like. Right around, there's the Miracle Man. Oh, he went for the cowboy. Just popped him up, I think, when he went around for the blind man. And then came down hard in the water.
Yeah, ended up with the Miracle Man.
Yeah, Miracle Man. He had a lot of rotations on that one. I think he'll still be happy.
Yeah, he's breathing hard there. Yeah,
he might have hurt himself a little bit.
Might be a little bit injured there. He seems to be breathing quite hard.
It did seem quite a bit of an impact for him. Let's hope he's okay.
This is a pretty
dangerous sport, but focused on safety. So these guys are within seconds. Medics on the standby. Maybe he's just got winded.
Yeah, it was quite a big impact. We'll see it now here on the replay.
Okay, he's got a lot of speed in the turn. Coming through, right round, goes for that, touching the water, but just popped up a little bit and carried him round for the full 360.
Let's see where he's getting the... Just down there onto his back. He's flipped his back, hasn't he?
And again around another 360. So difficult when you impact with the water, just a tiny bit hard, can pop you up, and then very difficult to complete the rest of the trick. He's back in the boat now.
Just waiting for the score there for Timmy Thompson. You can see in the aircraft, there's a pilot. And there is Kurt Bartholomew, world champion, set himself up. Travis Mills as well is next. Is he already out? He must be. Yeah, we've got a good shot of Timmy there. Yeah, he's waving to the crowd. He's got his smile back. There he is. The new up-and-coming talent here in Denmark. It's good to know you're okay there, Timmy. For one moment, we thought you were injured. But now setting up above us, off the corner of the lake, about to start his run, is Travis Mills.
Okay, so we've got Travis. He's going to be doing 450 as well. Method, cowboy to blind man. So Method is twisting in the harness at 90 degrees. We're looking for good contact with the water. Into the cowboy, taking the arm off and touching with the water. And then into the blind man. So a 180 degree in the harness. Let's see how he does. Out of the turn now. A lot of power. Oh, there's a bit of a crash. So he got the cowboy out. It looked like he got the Method as well, but then had a bit of an impact with the water.
Let's go to the interview with Timmy Thompson in the Irish.
I'm down here with Timmy Thompson, the Danish legend, putting his body on the line. Are you okay, first of all?
Yeah, it hurts a little bit. It hurts a lot.
It hurts a lot. We're going to get a medical person to you straight away. But before we go, how good is this Danish crowd and how good is Copenhagen?
Give it on! Hvad synes I? Jeg har det lige sådan. Det er mega fedt at være her. Det er pisse fedt at se jer alle sammen.
Injured man and still pleasing the crowd. Give it up for Timmy Thompson!
Thank you very much, Sir Irish. He is in a bit of pain. 5.7.3 was his score there. 41.9 in the first round, 5.7.3 in the second round. Travis Mills has just come through the course. He's on the safety boat now. In the door there, you can see the replay of Kurt Bartholomew's exit from the helicopter as he falls down towards this beautiful lake. You can see the pontoon there. What a great shot. How a studio and the pontoon and all the safety boats around it too. Travis Mills firing back now here to the jetty. Over to you, Irish, in an interview with Travis Mills.
Beautiful. We got Travis Mills out. He's trying to get the sun out because he's got those guns out. Travis, come on up here, buddy. Absolutely fantastic. Travis's first time here at Swoop Challenge, and he's made an impression on all of us. An athlete's favorite, a crowd favorite, and how could he not looking that good in a shirt like that? Here he comes now. Travis finishing off Swoop Challenge. Came in, was ranked 6, coming up. Give it up for Travis Mills! Travis, First of all, are you happy with your last jump?
Wasn't bad, man. Not my best work. Didn't quite get the move in that I wanted, but busted out a bigger turn than I'm not used to, so it was pretty good, man. It was nice.
And mostly, how's Swoop Challenge been for you?
Amazing, man. Thank you guys for having me here. It's been great.
Okay, thank you very much. We're going to go back to the studio.
Well, Travis put down a big score of 6-1.9 in round one, but look at the helmet cam now. We've got Kurt Bartholomew, world champion, being followed by the machine, Pablo Hernandez Mao. Live action that you're seeing on the big screen now, transmitted from the helmet of Pablo, watching Kurt Bartholomew. Mao.
Onto deep brakes. He's looking to go really big on this one. It's his last jump. It's a big 8-10 degree turn into the first 90, and then two more 360s, diving that canopy down at the ground, giving as much speed as possible. We're looking for a boomerang switchblade cowboy. So coming in is a carve and then transferring those toggles into one hand. There we go, he's got it, he's flying it. Oh, he's done it. He's on the pontoon. He's made it. What an amazing trick from Curtis. Excellent work.
World champion Kurt Bartholomew nails it onto the platform. That's what he's been looking for. That's going to be the move which is going to make a difference to the standings. 74.9 in his first round run, and that was fantastic. How were the tricks, though? We needed the boomerang, the switchblade, and the cowboy. What do you think? Did you get much of a view? We'll find out in a minute on the slow motion.
Well, it looked to me like he was smooth all the way through that. We've got the... Yes, he's got all three. He's got all three, and then flying it perfectly back onto the pontoon at the end. So he had the boomerang, looked to me like he had this, definitely had the switchblade. Quick touch on the water for the cowboy. Multiplied by 5.6, he's going to be definitely happy with that.
What an amazing reaction there from himself, from Kurt Bartholomew, as he slides it up onto the platform. We've got him heading back to the jetty for his interview right now. We're going to get the scores for Travis Mills and the score for Kurt Bartholomew very, very soon. Incredible footage having Pablo Hernandez on the helmet can, giving us all the action there. Incredible shot, showing him why he's been a multiple world champion. Kurt Bartholomew, over to you, Irish.
Kurt Bartholomew bringing the absolute noise. I'm here with Jeannie. Jeannie, how proud of your husband are you right now?
So proud. Yeah, baby. Woo!
Here he comes now, the world champion, Kurt Bartholomew, bringing it up slowly after showing why he is world champion. Running up, give it up for Kurt Bartholomew! Kurt, finishing off Swoop Challenge with an absolutely huge move. How did it feel for you?
Oh, man, it felt great. This is one of the first comps I've done an 810-degree turn, and I nailed the raft all three rounds, so I'm so stoked right now.
Absolutely fantastic. That's putting you in the running up there. So, Jeannie, how proud of you are you?
Oh, I'm so proud, honey. Yes.
Give him a kiss. The crowd wants to see it. Give it up for the Bartholomews.
Absolutely massive score there, Kurt Bartholomew, 85.5, smashing the competition out of the lake. Adding that to his first round, 74.9, that gives him a total of 160.40. Foggy.
Okay, now we've got Tom Baker with his signature move, the ginger flip. Everyone wants to see this. He's going to try and do a backflip through the rises. So he's going to be doing a 450 degree turn, bringing it around nice and slow.
Got getting, a great one on the round one.
Getting the canopy vertical there for the speed. Leveling out. He's got to touch the water before he tries this flip. There's touching the water all the way through.
Oh! Oh!
Just landing before the pontoon, but he was bang on target for that. Canopy didn't move once as he's going through those rises, I didn't see.
That was very similar to his first round this afternoon, wasn't it? It looked like, he's going for the method and the ginger, but the actual flip looked very similar to what we saw a moment ago.
Yeah, well, he's getting better and better at that move. He's been training for 2 months, just on this trick. And each one seems more solid. So he's got good contact with the water, keeps those rises level. Even just an inch left or right could put him in the water either to the left or the right. So he's getting more solid each time he does it.
Incredible. Look at that move.
Canopy doesn't move at all on that. The only man in the world doing that at the moment. Excellent work, Tom.
So Travis Mills, just a few competitors ago, he got a 51.02 for his second round performance, 61.9 for his first round. But the main story right now, the headline right now, is Kurt Bartholomew, 74.9 round one, 85.5 round two, giving a total of 160.40. Can anybody beat that? Can anybody take it away from him? We're going to find out in the next three competitors. We've got Christian Moxness, Claudio Cognazio, and Nick Batch, his teammate, still to come. Over to you, Irish.
Here comes the world's favourite ginger. Give it up for Tom Baker! Tom, you've had an absolutely fantastic Swoop challenge. You brought a new trick to the crowd that no one has ever seen before. How happy are you with your performance here this week?
Man, of course we always want to do better, but I'm super happy. All of them got around every single time. So we made the flip around, showed you guys something new. Next time, I'll make sure we land it on the raft for you guys.
Is there anything you'd like to say to this crowd right now?
Thank you guys so much. Give it up for Swoop Challenge!
Thank you very much, guys. Back to you in the studio.
Incredible there. Christian Moxness is going to be the next through the platform. Mark Foggy, take it over.
Yeah, this is the last three, or the first three in the rankings yesterday for qualifying. So we've got Christian Moxness, big turn. He does 8-10, maximum points of 10. And then on this round, he's going to be doing a lazy boy switch cowboy, so leaning right back in the harness, switching those toggles into one hand, and then putting one arm in the water as well. Maximum multiplier of 5.6, so let's see how he does this. He's on deep brakes now, waiting for that moment to start the dive, started the dive, bringing up the speed. He's a very smooth flyer, is Christian. You can see it in his turn, no real adjustment so far. One more 360 to go to get the last bit of power. There we go. Hands transferred to the rear rises. Looks solid on the course. Leaning right back. Hands into two toggles. He's on there. I thought he was going to be on the pontoon then. But great effort. Looks like he got the switchblade on that.
He did indeed. Well, we're down to the last few people here for this afternoon. Still to come, Nick Batch and Claudio Cognazio. It's all getting exciting and mixing it all up. We're down into the final few. We've got third place prize money of $2,500 US. Second place, $5,000. And the first place prize, $7,500. And we're playing for that right now. Could Cognazio or Nick Batch upset it? They certainly could, you know. We've got 75.1 round one from Nick Batch. 75.7 from Cognazio, and there is a replay of Moxness.
Looks like he just missed out on that cowboy, but he was really going for it. But the initial lazy boy looked lovely, leaning right back, swapping those toggles, and then just missing the water with his left hand. Tried to correct the canopy, it was moving to the left, tried to correct it onto the right, but just a little bit too much power there, slipped off into the water. But either way, he's got to be very, very, very happy with that round. Excellent work, Christian.
So Tom Baker there did get a 60.7 in his second round. We're going to go now to Irish and an interview with Moxness.
We've got Christian Mox coming up now, the Norway Viking bringing it in. Here he comes, he's a VIP favourite. Bring it on up, Christian. Christian, last year you finished lower down the table. You have absolutely brought the noise this year. How do you feel about your performance at Swoop Challenge this year?
No, amazing, Anna. I didn't really expect it at all. So it's all a pleasant surprise for me this year.
You're an absolute crowd favourite. Everyone loves you. You've got that smile on your face the whole time. Is there anything you'd like to say to the Copenhagen crowd right now?
Oh, thank you so much for having me, and I'm just having a super nice time here, so hope I'm coming back next year.
Beautiful, the coolest, friendliest Viking in the world. Christian Mox, back to you in the studio.
Well, a blistering score there by Moxness, 70.2. Adding that to his first round of 61.9 gives him a 1-3-2. Well, we're into the final few moments of this now. Who's going to be third? Who's going to be second? Who's going to be first? Who's going to take away $7,000, Foggy?
Well, let's see. We've only got two more flyers to go before the display. The next person to go is Claudio Cognazio from Venezuela. And he's going to be doing an 8-10 as well, so maximum points on the turn, 10 points he could gain on that, into a blind man switchblade cow switch for six multiplier.
Well, he actually beat Kurt Bartholomew in round one. He had a 75.7. Kurt Bartholomew had 74.9, so he just slightly pipped him in that round one score. But next up, with a multiplier of 6 against Kurt Bartholomew's multiplier of 5.6, it's all lined up for a tense final here. And then Nick Batch, he got 75.1 on his first round. Second round, if he can do anything with his 5.9 blind boom, it's all up for grabs. First, second, third. Who's it going to be? We're about to find out. Claudio Cannazio, Foggy.
Well, this is going to be a big trick if he can pull it off. Turning 180 in the degrees in the harness, switching those toggles into one hand, putting the one arm in the water as well, switching back around for the 180, and then putting the toggles into his hand again.
Yes.
So let's go. See, he's lined up on the course now. He's going for the blind man, arm in the water for the cowboy, and he's got around again. I don't think he got the last switch, but he's onto the pontoon, hugging on for dear life. Well done, Claudio. Excellent run.
Well, incredible. It's going to be a nail-biting finish. Is that going to be enough to catch up with Kurt Bartholomew with his 160.40? Is it going to be enough? We've got the slow-mo here.
Here we go. Left hand, 810-degree turn. A lot of power, nice and smooth into the... He did touch the water then, nice. I think he just ran out of time to get that last switch blade in. But
what about that landing though? Is that going to be classed as a landing on the platform? I don't know, eh?
Well, I think he touched it. Let's just have a look on this last piece of footage. He's gone over to the right-hand side to get it. Tricky to tell. He's definitely touched it, so...
He's going to need something special to catch up to that first place.
I think so.
Oh, right now, 75.7 is what he had in the first round. We're going to find out very shortly what his score is. He's getting onto the boat. Still to come, Nick Batch. He can turn it on incredibly at the last minute. Nick Batch can just pull things out of the air. We've seen him in competition worldwide. He'll just always neck and neck with Kurt Bartholomew. This is Swoop Challenge 2016. Ladies and gentlemen, using parachutes does not get more exciting than this. It's as good as it gets. We are going to get Nick Batch out and down here very, very shortly. And it's all over. We're just waiting now for Claudio to make his way through to the final podium and his final interview with Irish. Wow, Foggy, can you believe what we're seeing?
No, what are we saying? I'm looking.
We've been watched worldwide and we are on a live feed too. Over to Irish for that final interview.
Okay, we have got the guys coming in now, and it looks like Claudio has made the effort. He is looking as good as anyone could after landing in the water. I think, crowd, do you want to see him strut? You want to see him catwalk up the platform? He's a crowd favorite. Claudio, show us your moves! That's it, give us a twirl! Yeah, disco party night. Come on up, Claudio, come on up. Claudio from Venezuela, fly for life, absolutely fantastic. We're just going to have a quick word with you. Happy with that last jump?
It was looking pretty good. Threw me a little bit on the side and missed the raft. But I'm pretty happy with it. Stayed for a long time on the water. I think that's going to give me a pretty decent score.
Beautiful, thank you very much. We're going back to the studio for Nick Batch. Let's see if he can take it.
Claudio, 71.9, added to his 75.7, gives him a total of 147.7. Kurt Bartholomew before him with 160.40. Nick Batch is the only person now left who can upset this score. Bull Foggy, it's you.
He's starting his 810 degree turn, and he's hoping to do a blind boomerang. So this is his signature move. Coming around with the carve and then looking the other way. Looks he's good. He's going to try and fly it onto the pontoon. Can he do it? He's touched. He's on the pontoon again. This man never gets wet.
Oh, wow, incredible. Nick Batch pulls it out of the bag and pulls himself down onto the pontoon with a first round score of 75.1 against Kurt Bartholomew, 74.9. Bartholomew came back with an 85.5. What's Batch going to get for that? Finishing off the Swoop Challenge competition, bang in the middle of the podium. It doesn't get any more exciting. Let's have a look at the replay.
Well, he really has practiced his move a lot and a lot. Getting the wing over there, trying to get his body 180 degrees behind, but I think he realized he was a little bit far away, so really extended the range of the canopy to try and get himself on the pontoon, which he managed to very, very nicely. Well done, Nick. Incredible. Looking the other way as well. He's not even looking where he's going. It's just perfect.
I didn't think he was going to make the pontoon from the angle that we could see it on the monitor, but look at his face. He's absolutely incredibly ecstatically relieved to have done that and to have nailed it. He's on the boat. He's making his way to the platform. Ladies and gentlemen, Nick Batch, has he done enough? Is he going to take it out of the hands of his teammate, Kurt Bartholomew? Over to you, Irish.
We have Nicholas Batch coming down the platform now after a sensational round one. Round two, sum it up for us. Are you happy with round two? Do you think you've taken the title?
You know, it was a really tough round for me with the, as it was for everybody with the lighting conditions. It's awesome to be out here. I don't know if that took it or not. I did get around, so it was nice. I came up a little short, so I had to fly to the barge, but that was worth it. So.
But it's team alter ego in two, and then that move, you could take it, so we've got Kurt and you on top. How are you feeling?
A little ecstatic, a little excited. We'll see how it goes. You know how this comp is. It's really difficult, so we'll see what the judges have to say.
And after the Swoop Challenge is over now, you're the last person to run it. We don't know who hasn't won yet. We're waiting for the score. Swoop Challenge in one. What do you think of the event?
I'll tell you what. It's even bigger and better than last year. I can't wait till next year. Let's get a world tour started and let's show the world what we're doing.
Absolutely fantastic. I'll join you on that one so we can have some fun. Thank you very much, Nick.
Thank you for letting me perform. It's been great.
Beautiful. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thank you very much, Irish. Well, it's an incredible finish here tonight. We've got the finals on the scoreboard. Look, you can see it there. Third place, Claudio Cognazio, 147.6. Second place, Nick Batch, 152.8. But the champion of Swoop Challenge 2016 with a blistering 160.4, Kurt Bartholomew. Incredible, what a final. Wow, let's run it down there, what we had. Incredible, Kurt Bartholomew now taking the cheers and the hugs from his wife. Nick Batch doesn't know what to do with himself. He thought he'd nailed it. Irish, over to you.
Kurt Bartholomew, you are 2016 Swoop Challenge champion!
Woo! Yeah, man. I'm so excited right now.
How's your emotions? How are you feeling? You've just taken out the biggest Swoop comp in the world.
Oh, man, I'm feeling awesome, man. My turn is what helped me back last year, so I busted out the 810s this year, and I was able to throw it all together, so I'm so excited right now.
That last jump took it home for you. You must be happy with everything you've done this week.
Oh, yeah, man. We've been working really hard. Me and Jeannie have been training at home a lot for this particular competition, so really happy with everybody on the team, and thank you so much to all the organizers for having us out here, and for Copenhagen, woo!
Jeannie, come over here. Jeannie, come over here. How proud of you are this big, massive hunk now who's 2016 Swoop Challenge champion?
Oh, I'm super proud. Words can't even describe what I'm feeling right now.
Absolutely fantastic. Kurt, you are champion. You're champion of Swoop Challenge. We'll see you guys back next year to defend your title. Kurt Bartholomew, 2016 Swoop Challenge champion!
What an incredible final. My arms are tingling from all the excitement. Foggy, what did you make of that?
Everyone did so well. You know, it was a bit tight at the end with the scoring and everything, but really Kurt came through and just busted everybody out of the water. Well done, Kurt.
You couldn't ask for a better final. I know it's tight and it's hard on the people that are 1 or 2 points behind when you lose out like that, but wow, it makes good television. It really does.
So close all the way through.
Kurt Bartholomew nailed it down right into the centre of the pontoon, and people have been doing it all afternoon as well. Incredible, really, what we've just seen. I can't believe how close it was. I'm here in the studio with our great guest, Chris Ferlin. How are you, Chris?
Hey, well, thank you. Well, thank you.
You're here. Is that your name, Ferlin? Have I got that correct?
Yes, Ferlin. That's correct.
Chris, you're from the Danish Paragliding Association, I do believe.
That is correct. From the Danish Paragliding Association.
Well, welcome to the studio with me and Matt. We're still coming down from what we've just seen there with the final. Let's take a breath and just think about that. Wow. So, Chris, what have we got going on? We've got some paragliding action. We saw them at the Frederiksberg Gardens. Explain a little bit what's going to be happening.
This is the same group. Today they're going to be doing something slightly different. What you saw in Frederiksberg, that was individual flying. Today we're going to have some synchro flying, where there's going to be two coming out at the same time. They're going to be doing some acrobatic maneuvers.
Yeah.
Acrobatic paraglider uses a special type of paraglider that's rated up to 12 Gs. Some of the maneuvers you'll see today, they'll be pulling 6 Gs where they'll be rotating around the parachute. So hopefully it will go well, and if we're lucky, they will land on the pontoon here.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, everybody here in the audience, all around the world watching, that's what we're going to be seeing next. One trick I know is infinity tumbles. That's the only one I know. Tell us a bit what that is.
The infinity tumble, that's if you have a paraglider chute here, they go around and around and around. And I can't remember the exact number for the world record, but it is over 300.
Wow.
Where they go around and around and around.
And the way they fly these machines is incredible. We have them almost like collapsing in on themselves. And I'm going to check the sky. I'm just going to move back from the studio and have a look now. We can see, oh, we've actually got one of your guys out. Do you want to just move back a little bit, Chris?
Yeah.
Not too far. You don't want to fall in the water. But I think we'll switch to the view of the sky and we'll have a look at these paragliding champions. So who have we got here, Chris? Do you know who's going first?
I'm not sure the order, but it's a team from Norway, and they're pretty much professional.
How many people have you got here then this week for the paragliding?
We've got three jumpers, pilots, and then we have a jump master who's helping them come out of the helicopter. They use a D-bag where they have like a bag where the paraglider is packed in, similar to that you have on your back, so it's a skydiver. And then they just hop out, do a free fall of about 10 meters, and then the paraglider comes out.
How long does the packing take? I mean, an expert parachute packer can put it away in 5 minutes. What about these things?
I'm pretty sure it takes a little bit longer.
Tell us a little bit about the Gs you were talking about. Is 1G your body weight?
Yes. So as you increase the speed and the maneuver, so the G-force obviously increases. And when you're doing the acro maneuvers, you want to keep your glider open, of course.
Hey guys, just want to inform everybody as well that we have got the prize ceremony of Swoop Challenge coming up. So while we've got the paragliding action in the sky, don't leave anywhere. We've got all the action still to come. We're going to be getting all the winners of Swoop Challenge. In fact, all the competitors, we're going to take them out onto the platform. We're going to take them out to the platform before we actually finish for today. So don't go anywhere yet, ladies and gentlemen. Still lots of great images to be seen. All the competitors will be out there on the platform. Back to the action with the paragliding. So what we're going to do actually, just while we wait for the paragliders to come a little bit closer, they're a bit far away right now, we're going to have a look at a replay at that winning round from Kurt Bartholomew. Here he is, Foggy, look at this. All his runs, we're looking at all his runs here. So this was, I think, the first run from yesterday, from the practice round, or is it for no? It's from today because he didn't land on the.
He's landed on the pontoon there. Just having a look at.
And his next run now, Foggy's coming up as well. There you go. Look at him punching the sky. Absolutely loving it. This is what you're watching right now, ladies and gentlemen. Is the action you've seen from the new Swoop Challenge champion, Kurt Bartholomew, on what he's done today? Let's have a look at the next one. He's happy there, being collected onto the boat. Just a reminder, don't go anywhere yet, people. We're going to take all our competitors out to the platform on the centre for the prize-giving ceremony. And here goes the beautiful shot, the beauty shot of lovely Pebblinger Beach. Remember, $7,000, $5,000 second and $2,500 for the third.
And it looks like these paragliders started their tricks now. They've got the smoke on.
You can see a great shot of all our competitors being taken out onto the boat. It looks like Irish is going to join him as well. Don't drop that broadcast mic. Oh, Nick Batch wobbling it from the back. Yeah, it's been a great few days of entertainment. The weather forecast was against us all week long, but we stuck firm and stuck steady and put the show on and brought it to you, urban skydiving to the people. The paragliders now, Chris, do you want to tell us again about what we can see?
Yeah. Right now, it looks like they're about to start their maneuvers. They'll be lining up, and then hopefully they'll start off with a wing over. I assume very similar to the skydiving wing over. You start the one side swing and then swing up over your own wing, and then from there they'll be going into the infinity tumbling that you named, where you go over your own parachute, and then they'll be going into what's called a helicopter, where they'll rotate around 360 degrees on their parachute, keeping it flat, which is quite a difficult maneuver, where you stall one side of the paraglider and keep the other side flying.
There's obviously a lot less pressure in these types of canopy than the parachutes, our type of parachutes. Is that the, which maneuver is this?
Yeah, this is where they're just doing the synchro spiral, where they're spiraling around and having their canopies with each other. It involves a lot of timing. They need to be very precise, especially there's a risk that they can, of course, twist the canopies around each other, and then they're going to have a problem.
What would happen then? Do they have a reserve parachute like we do?
Yeah, they have a reserve parachute. The difference is they don't have a breakaway system.
Okay.
So it's hopefully you throw it out and try and get your paraglider in.
I did see one type of harness the other day with a three-ring system on.
Yeah. That's a new design, where they can jettison if necessary. Most of the acro paragliding harnesses have two parachutes, a reserve and an extra reserve.
Oh, wow.
Wow, incredible. I didn't realize that.
And it's a risk of the infinity tumbling. You always risk falling down into your own paraglider where you're unable to release your paraglider. So you need to have a backup.
And so they're going to land on the podium, and is that the idea? They're going to land on the platform?
As far as I know.
Well, let's see how they can do that.
It's incredible how long they stay up compared to the canopies we've been seeing today. You can go long distances with these.
Quite. They are designed to fly.
So once these guys are down and on the ground and on the podium, I think we're going to move them off then with the boat, or they're going to join in with our competitors for Swoop Challenge 2016. There we go, diving round. Wow, look at the move. Incredible, ladies and gentlemen. Give them a big round of applause. Come on, let's hear it.
So what's this maneuver he was just doing called?
Yeah, he was just doing a spiral, where he's spiraling down.
Or collapsing the canopy
there.
Yes,
and now he's just on a full stall, where he stalled the canopy. And this is the infinity tumbling that we talked about, where they're flying over their own paraglider there.
Wow.
And there's a large risk that they can, of course, if they don't have enough speed on it, that they'll fall down into the paraglider. Wow.
Incredible to watch. Right in the middle of the bunch. Well done, incredible to watch. Such a lovely black backdrop now with the pink sky and everything.
And these canopies are all the same? Are they the same
style? Yeah, these three are.
Yeah.
Yeah. Of course, there are different variations of it. Or there's more differences, but these are the same.
Let's see whether number two can get on.
Ooh. They should all be able to land quite accurately.
Oh, 10 points for the
stand-up. Oh, no. Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause for our paragliders, and thank you to our member of the Danish Parachute Federation, Chris Merlon. Thanks for joining us in the studio, Chris. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
In the meantime, the boats are getting ready to make their way to the centre podium, where we have what has now become a tradition here at Swoop Challenge, the prize giving. And it's that iconic image that we saw last year, the Czechs being held high as the champions become icons, become heroes of this amazing emerging sport. And you've watched it live here. Remember, the first test event was 2014 here in Copenhagen and Pebblingersø. Then we had the championship last year, and now we are back 2016. Copenhagen is the birthplace. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to take this sport to the world. There's going to be a world tour, and these athletes are going to tour. That's what we want to get to. We're going to go over to Irish right now on the boat.
I can hear you now. I can hear you now. Oh, I'm online. Hello, everybody! Big smile out there! Here with the boat, with the competitors. How are you guys feeling? I think they're enjoying themselves. I'm not really sure, though. We're coming up here now. I'm going to jump off first. We're getting all the competitors on here. Absolutely fantastic show from the paragliders. All right. Okay. We got guys slipping left, right, and center. They're jumping on from every angle. It's still a little bit wet out here. It is still slippy. Crowd, this is the 20 best skydivers in the world. They are here to enter for Swoop Challenge. Have you guys enjoyed Swoop Challenge? We can do better than that. Have you guys enjoyed Swoop Challenge? There we go. That's the Copenhagen crowd we like to hear. Guys, it's been an absolute pleasure. You live in the best city in the world with the best people in the world. I'm struggling to stand up here, guys. Absolutely fantastic. It is seriously slippy out here. The boats are coming up now. We have the big Czechs coming out. Out here.
Thank you very much, Iris. Well, it's great to have you out there. Don't fall in, my friend. Don't lose that microphone. The next boat is on its way out, and I think they're just leaving the dock right now. What a great final this has been. It's good, such memories from last year at Swoop Challenge. I hope all you people watching around the lake have enjoyed it. Have you enjoyed the show? Yeah, I'm sure you have. We've got a great crowd here behind the studio. Nice to see you all, everybody. All the people on the bridge, I can't wait to get the numbers of how many people we've had down here watching live. And all the people worldwide on the two live streams we've had going out. And we've been out on national Danish television as well on Esther de Blad. It's good of those guys to join us down here this afternoon. Thank you very much for your time, ladies and gentlemen. The second boat almost reaching there with the goodie bags from Lanson and Brugard, but more importantly, the big checks. Third place, $2,500 US, $5,000 for second place, and first place, $7,500. That's what these guys are taking home with them this afternoon, making their way onto the platform. I don't think we've ever had this many people on there. Last year, it was only the competitors. We've got